Very good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
A very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Everything is set to start the orientation program for the students of 2019 and 2020's orientations program. Let's start the program. And prior to that, we have set a small introduction video for you all to experience the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, University of Colombo.
The Institute of Indigenous Medicine is the pioneer institute in Ayurveda and Yunani medicine affiliated to the University of Colombo. Founded as the College of Indigenous Medicine in 1929, it became a part of the University of Colombo, adopting its current name in 1977. This is the inauguration ceremony of the orientation program for the students of the academic year 2019-2020. Senior Professor Chandrika N. Vijayaratna, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Colombo, is an alumnus and an academic in Reproductive Medicine and Endocrinology, Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo. She has an unfailing research record with multi-sector and international collaboration and outreach. Senior Professor Priyani Parunagama, the Director of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, who is a recipient of many national and international awards and patents, has produced a number of postgraduate students, supervised PhD and MPhil research students, published over 40 publications in peer-reviewed journals, and presented over 80 communications in national and international symposia. Dr. S.P. Molligoda, Head, Department of Study in Ayurveda. Professor M.S.M. Shifa, Head, Department of Study in Yunani. The institutional structure of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Department of Study in Ayurveda. Unit of Maulika Siddhanta, Unit of Dravdiguna Vinyana, Unit of Allied Sciences, Unit of Swasthavruta, Unit of Kaya Chikitsa, Unit of Deshiya Chikitsa, Unit of Prasuti Tantra and Kaumara Vrutya, Unit of Shalya Shalakya, Department of Study in Yunani, Unit of Kulliyat, Unit of Ilmul Adwiya, Unit of Allied Sciences, Unit of Tahavuziwa Samaji Tib, Unit of Molijat, Unit of Deshiya Ilaj, Unit of Amras A. Nizwan Kwabalat Wu Atfal, Unit of Ilmul Jarahat. Units under the Department of Study in Ayurveda. The unit of Maulika Siddhanta, which concerns on the basic principles of Ayurveda medicine, is one of the major units of the institute. Covering the areas of Ayurveda history, Samhita text which reveals the practices related with this medical system, this unit provides the students to learn the roots of Ayurveda. Equipping the academic career with modern and traditional techniques of drug preparation and drug standardization, scientific validation, knowledge regarding scientific ways of research, organizing field visits, herbal plant identification programs, and even maintaining a herbal garden in Valigatta is done by the unit of Dravdiguna Vinyana. Proceeding with the basic sciences of Ayurveda and as well as modern medicine, dissection of the human body and related knowledge in anatomy, modern laboratory techniques along with the knowledge of physiology is derived through the unit of Allied Sciences. Knowledge related to the preventive methods related in Ayurveda community medicine, public and school awareness programs, yoga lessons, field visits, and many more sessions are conducted through the unit of Swasthavruta to enhance the related knowledge in students. Along with OPD and IPD practices, the unit of Kai Chikitsa provides students with the Ayurvedic clinical medical knowledge with the treatments and relevant applications. Preserving the traditional medical knowledge with the support of renowned indigenous physicians, the unit of Desiya Chikitsa gives the students the hand-on skill. Unit of Prasuti Tantra and Kaumara Brutya provides students with the knowledge of Ayurveda gynecology and obstetrics. ENT and also the knowledge related to eye, mouth related and dental practices along with surgical theatre experience at the teaching hospital are facilitated to the students through the unit of Shalya Shalakya. Units under the Department of Yunani. Unit of Kulya strives to bring about progression in the science of Yunani fundamental medicine through innovation and enterprise. Unit of Ilmul Adwiya deals with the identification of single drugs and preparation of compound drugs such as plant, animal and mineral origin. This unit also involves in field visits to herbariums and drug corporations. Unit of Allied Sciences deals with the modern medical basic science subjects such as anatomy, physiology, and biochemistry. Practical demonstrations were provided in well-equipped laboratories. Unit of Tahafuzivo Samaji Tib involves several activities such as conducting special OPD at Ayurveda Teaching Hospital in Borella and health awareness and health promotion programs under community engagement in various parts of Sri Lanka. Unit of Bolijan mainly deals with the undergraduates' clinical programs. The clinical training is mainly provided at the Teaching Hospital of Ayurveda. The academic unit established a regimental therapy unit recently to upgrade the regimental therapy. Unit of Desiya Ilaj offers lectures and practical trainings on Yunani traditional medicine. It plays an important role in disseminating knowledge and developing skills of the undergraduates with expected competencies in traditional medicine. Unit of Amras A. Nizwan Kwabalat Wo Atfal offers lectures and practical trainings on Yunani gynecology, obstetrics and pediatrics. Training the undergraduates to manage pediatrics, gynecology, and obstetric problems with appropriate Yunani treatment modalities. Unit of Ilmul Jarahat offers lectures and practical trainings on Yunani surgery and ear, nose, throat diseases. Apart from the academic units, many other facilities are centered with the Institute of Indigenous Medicine. The National Ayurveda Teaching Hospital in Borella facilitates the students to participate in OPD, IPD, surgery and clinics, allowing them to have the practical knowledge. Ayurveda Wellness Center basically focuses on the preventive aspect of Ayurveda medicine and even they offer optional subjects such as beauty culture and several aspects of Panchakarma such as leech therapy. The ICT laboratory focuses on the students to develop their knowledge with the modern technology. The IIM library facilitates the students with a wide range of collection of books and even maintaining an Ola Leaf book collection. The greenhouse and medicinal plant house provides students to be benefited of experiencing real plants for their study purposes. Food corner, playground and the lecture theatres, study halls and study areas provide students a calm and facilitated environment to their study and leisure activities. Among the special events organized in the institute, the International Conference on Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha and Traditional Medicine, student performances, Ayurveda educational exhibitions, activities of Ayurveda and Yunani students relieving their tensions, student counselor service, student awareness programs such as drug awareness, reproductive health, forming ISEC and Rotaract clubs, cultural events, blood donation campaigns, Sinhala and Hindu New Year celebrations, and even sports takes a prominent place with achievements in the interfaculty levels and even representing the entire university in foreign tours. Where you can gain your higher education in a calm environment. Be a professional. Congratulations for your future. Welcome to the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, University of Colombo.
සුබ උදෑසනක්. පෙරබර වූ අනාගතයක බලාපොරොත්තු වේ සුබ සිහින පිබිදෙන මේ උදෑසන කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලීය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනයේ වර්ෂ 2019-2020 අධ්‍යන ශිෂ්‍ය කණ්ඩායමේ සිය සරසවි ප්‍රවිෂ්ඨයේ සමාරම්භක උළෙල හා එක්වන සම්භවනීය අමුත්තනි දෙමව්පියනි දුව දරුවනි ඔබ සැම මේ සුවිශේෂී මොහොතට සාදරයෙන් පිළිගනු ලබනවා. පවත්න COVID-19 සංක්‍රමණකත්වය හමුවේ අප දෛනික ක්‍රියාපටිපාටිෙහි සිදුවන විවිධ වෙනස්වීම් වලට අනුගත වෙමින් කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ඔබගේ බලපොරොත්තු සවිගැන්වීමට දරන සාර්ථක පරිශ්‍රමයක ප්‍රතිඵලයක් ලෙස ඔබ අප මෙම මාර්ගගත හමුවේ පාර්ශ්වකරුවන් වී ඇත. බෙන්ජමින් ෆ්‍රැන්ක්ලින් වර්ග ප්‍රකාශ කර සිටිනවා අධ්‍යාපනය දැනුම නැමැති ප්‍රතිලාභය අතිග්‍රහණය කළ හැකි වටිනාම ආයෝජනය ලෙස. එදා මෙදා තුර වූ මානව ප්‍රගමනය ඊට සාක්ෂි දරනුයේ අනාගත සත්‍යතාවයක පෙරවදනක් මෙනි. අතිකින් පරිපූර්ණිත විචක්ෂණශීලී වූ පරිපාලන යාන්ත්‍රණයක් මෙහෙයවීම තුළින් විශ්ව ප්‍රණාලියේ සංවර්ධනයේ අධ්‍යතන පරපුර නිර්මාණයෙහිලා වෙසෙස් කැපවන සිහල දෙරණ මත චරිත සුවහසක් විද්‍යාර්ථීන්ගේ චන්ද්‍ර භූමිය වූ මෙසිරලක විශිෂ්ටතම විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ලෙස කිරුළු පළන් කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ පාර්ශ්ව කරුණක වීමේ ප්‍රහර්ෂය සමග එක්ව පුරාවසර 90ක් ඉක්මනු කාලයක් පුරාවට හෙළවෙද දරුන් සයුරේ අභිමානනීය තක්සලාව වූ කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලීය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාවේ අත්පොත්තබන්නා වූ නූතන පරම්පරාවේ තත්කාලීන සම්පත් අවශ්‍යතාවයන් සපුරාලමින් ශක්්‍යතා පූර්ණිත ආයුර්වේද සහ යුනානි වෛද්‍ය වෘත්තිකයන් සමාජගත කිරීමේ බාරදූර වගකීමේ නියම වී ඇත. මෙතැන් පටන් එම සුපහන් අරමුණෙහි ඔබද කොටස්කරුවකු වන්නේ ආකල්ප හා කුසලතාවයන්ගෙන් යුතු වෛද්‍ය වෘත්තිකයකු වීමේ වගකීම පෙරදැරිවයි. ඉඳින් ඔබට පියනගන්නට අවසරයි.
அறிமுக காணொளியை கண்டுகளித்த அனைவருக்கும் என் அன்பான காலை வந்தனங்கள். அஸ்ஸலாமு அலைக்கும் வரஹ்மத்துல்லாஹி வபரகாத்துஹு. ஆய் போவன் வணக்கம். உயர் கல்வியில் உன்னதமீட்டிய நீங்கள் வரலாற்றில் 92 வருடங்களை பூர்த்தி செய்த உன்னாட்டு மருத்துவ நிர்வாகத்தில் கால் தடம் பதித்து இலங்கையின் முதன்மை பல்கலைக்கழகமாம் கொழும்பு பல்கலைக்கழகத்தின் மாணவர்களாகிய அதிர்ஷ்டசாலிகளான உங்களை நேரில் காண முடியாத துர்பாக்கிய நிலையிலும் கூட உங்கள் உயர்கல்வியை இணையதளம் வாயிலாக தொடர வாய்ப்பு கிடைத்ததில் எல்லாம் வல்ல இறைவனுக்கு நன்றி கூறுவோம்.
Once again, a pleasant morning to each and everyone, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, parents, students, and everyone behind this virtual gathering. Let me first congratulate you for calling, the choice of calling, actually, which offers a combination of intellectual and moral interest, which cannot be found in any other profession. Adapting to the new normal, we are conducting this event, adopting the health protective guidelines, wearing a face mask and maintaining the social distancing and sanitizing the environment frequently. So, ladies and gentlemen, the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, University of Colombo, is an institute which offers education in Ayurveda and Yunani medical systems, rendering a tremendous service for more than 9 decades. Today, you will become a part of this incredible and responsible scope of this institute. Without any further delay, now let's proceed for the proceedings of this orientation program for the students of the academic year 2019-2020. Ladies and gentlemen, to welcome you all on a more formal note, I would like to invite the effective and efficient leadership, the dedication, courage, and intention towards reaching the best, harvesting the best, steering to reach the success in the field of indigenous medicine by strengthening and facilitating the young generation with timely essentials is a fortune. Ladies and gentlemen, she is none other than the director of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, University of Colombo, Senior Professor Priyani A. Paranagama. Madam, over to you.
Aibowan, Assalamualaikum, welcome. Vice Chancellor, Senior Professor Chandrika Vijayaratna, Senior Student Counselor Dr. Rajita De Silva, heads of the departments Dr. S. Mollygoda and Professor S. M. Shifa, Senior Assistant Student Counselor Dr. Anoma Samaravikraman, all the heads of the units, all the academic staff members, Deputy Registrar, Mr. Dalit Walrasurya, Security Consultant, Major General Piyal Abhesekara, Administrative and non-academic staff members, my dear students and parents. It gives me a great pleasure and honor to welcome all of you to the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, IIM, University of Colombo. I'm very happy to inform you there are about 237 students registered for BMS and BMS program. They all joined today to this inauguration ceremony. Considering the prevailing pandemic situation in the country, it was decided to commence this program in virtual way, and also the rest of the orientation program will be conducted online too. First of all, let me congratulate all of you for your excellent performance at the advanced levels. All of you know, getting into a national university is not an easy task. Now you have been selected to follow an indigenous medical degree. So you will be in the Indigenous Institute of Indigenous Medicine and going to be an indigenous medical doctor after 5 years after successful completion of this degree program. Our aim is to produce medical graduates in Ayurveda or Unani who are committed to the well-being of patients, community, and society as responsible, accountable, capable, caring doctors. You know that both medical systems are common and popular medical systems in Sri Lanka. Therefore, you need to understand you are going to start a new life from today and going to be part of Institute of Indigenous Medicine. So far, most of your decisions are taken by your parents, but now the situation will be different because you become a responsible and independent person. But in the modern world, many forget about their parents, teachers, or guardians. We wanted to be an indigenous medical doctor by maintaining high standard and high values with all good qualities, traditions that we maintain in Sri Lanka. During the period you are at IIM, give a priority for yourself, your studies, and also maintain a good communication with the academic staff members. They are the ones who help you to get the education and to become a medical, Ayurvedic medical doctor. This period is different from the time you spend in school. This is your university life, I assure. There is no ragging at IIA. That is something that very important I want to inform you. You can discuss with the senior students, especially the student in 2017-18 and 2018-19 batch. They will let you know the life they had in the university. I must thank the academic staff members and also the administrative staff and also our senior students who help us to maintain ragging-free environment. And also, you need to know that we have zero tolerance for ragging. If we receive any complaint against ragging, we take the prompt action. So therefore, we are part of the University of Colombo, and also all the students at IIM now know that IIM is given a prestigious position as we affiliated the University of Colombo. And also, you need to know, other than the academic work, you will be given an opportunity to participate all the other extracurricular activities organized at University of Colombo. So, as we demonstrated in our video, you get the opportunity to develop your soft skills. Please join the activities given by or organized by Rotaract Club, Gravel Club, bicycles, and also the sport activities like, you know, the cricket, volleyball, netball, and also badminton, chess. There are many other sports activities that are done, that are organized by the University of Colombo. I encourage you to participate in those activities and strengthen the interaction with the students in the other faculties of the university. Our Vice Chancellor look forward to see you getting awards from your performance when you participate in the faculty events. So unfortunately, with this, you know, the COVID condition, we couldn't do that, but in future, you'll be able to participate those events too. And also, indigenous medicine has become indispensable because of its unique approach, and the IIM curricula is prepared to suit with that and also allow you to study the traditional healthcare system in the field of medical education. So IIM provide brilliant opportunity to our undergraduate student who enter the University of Colombo to expand your knowledge, skills on indigenous medicine with hands-on experience on Ayurveda medical system or Yunani medical system. My prime objective is to establish state-of-the-art faculty of indigenous medicine, which include Ayurveda medical system, Yunani medical system, and traditional medical system, which is unique to Sri Lanka. So through that, conducting teaching, clinical studies, research, and to disseminate the indigenous medical knowledge and uplift the indigenous medical system in Sri Lanka. The activities of IIM are empowered through academics who are involved in teaching both BAMS and UMS. They have been trained in multidisciplinary fields related to indigenous medicine, and they offer quality service in teaching and also when they do research activities. Our institute, affiliated with Ayurveda Teaching Hospital Borella, to provide clinical-based healthcare system in a holistic way. Students are given clinical-based exposure before complete their degrees. The teaching hospital, as you know, armed with consultant, IPD, OPD services, and there are traditional medical system unit like eye treatment, traditional orthopedic treatment, snake bite treatment, yoga unit, acupuncture unit, physiotherapy unit, so many. So ultimate goal of our institute is to produce knowledgeable, skilled, and also skilled doctor in Ayurveda and Yunani system of medicine. I'm pretty certain that the dynamic team of all our academic, administrative staff, non-academic staff, and all the other stakeholders, especially students and parents, we will be able to achieve the targets of Institute of Indigenous Medicine. And you will be staying with us for next 5 years. And also, this message is for our parents who are watching this inauguration orientation webinar today. So your son, daughter, enter the university from today and also start a new chapter of life. But remember, you need to be with them and follow what they do. And we will organize a separate meeting with the parents when we can meet physically. Before wind up, let me talk a few words in Sinhala now. Ada dina, dedas dahanamaya, dedas visa, adina varshayata, pemini, obba siyalu dina, adina, anadina, paripala, karyamandala wenwen, mama sadarin piligannawa. දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනයේ අධ්‍යක්ෂතුමිය හැටියට ඔබ සැම සාදරයෙන් පිළිගන්නවා. ආයුර්වේද හා යුනානි වෛද්‍යකම සම්බන්ධව උපාධිය ලබා ගැනීමේ අරමුණින් මේ වෙනකොට 237ක් ශිෂ්‍යයන් ලියාපදිංචි වී අද දින මෙම වෙබිනාරයකට සහභාගී වී සිටිනවා. අපි බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන්නේ මේ සියලු දෙනාටවත් බලාපොරොත්තුන් සිටියේ ඇත්තටම ඔබ සියලු දෙනාම සහ ඔබේ දෙමව්පියන් සමග මේ ආයතනයට ආරාධනා කරලා පිළිගැනීමේ උත්සවයක් පැවැත්වීමට. නමුත් අද දින පවතින මේ කොවිඩ් වසංගත තත්ත්වයෙන් ඉඳලා අපිට ඒක නොහැකි වුණා. පසුගිය වසරේත් අපිට ඒක හැකි වුණා අපි බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා ඉදිරි වසරේවත් අපිට ඒ තත්ත්වයට ඇති වෙවි කියලා ඉතින් මේ ආකාරයට ඔන්ලයින් විදියට මාර්ගගත ක්‍රම ඔස්සේ මෙබ සමාරම්භක උත්සවය පැවැත්වීමට තීරණය කළා ඒ වගේම තමයි මේ ඔරියන්ටේෂන් ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑම් එකේ ඉදිරි වැඩ කටයුතුත් අපි ඔන්ලයින් ආකාරයට සිදු කරගෙන යනවා මේතනදී මම විශේෂයෙන් කියන්න ඕන ඉතාමත් සතුටුයි අපි පොඩි සර්වේ එකක් කළා මේ නවක සිසුන්ට කොයි ආකාරයට මේ උත්සවයට සහ මේ ඉදිරි ඔන්ලයින් ක්‍රම අතර ක්‍රම ભેදේ යටතේ සහභාගී විය හැකිද කියන එක ඒකට අපිට දැනුනේ 97%කට එන්න පුළුවන් මේ සහභාගී වෙන හැබැයි අපි ඉතුරු 3%වත් අහක දාන්නේ අපි අය හඳුනාගෙන ඒ අය තියෙන අඩුපාඩු මග අරලා මේ පාඨමාලාව ඔන්ලයින් ක්‍රමයේ යටතේ පවත්වාගෙන යන්න කටයුතු කරනවා ඉතින් ඔබ සියලු දෙනාම දැනගත යුතු කරුණක් තමයි ආයුර්වේද හා යුනානි වෛද්‍ය ක්‍රම ඉතාමත් වැදගත් ඒ වගේම පිළිගන්නා ලෝකෙම පිළිගන්නා වෛද්‍ය ක්‍රම ටිකක් වලට පත් වෙලා තියෙනවා සමහර බටහිර වෛද්‍ය ක්‍රම වලින් සුව කළ නොහැකි ලෙඩ පවා මෙම ක්‍රම වෛද්‍ය ක්‍රම යටතේ සුව කිරීමට හැකි බව පෙන්වා දී තියෙනවා ඒ නිසා මේ වෛද්‍ය ක්‍රම හැදෑරීමට එන ඔබට ලොකු වගකීමක් තියෙනවා නිසි ආකාරයට මෙම උපාධිය හදාරලා මේ වෛද්‍යකම තියෙන ඒ දැනුම ලබාගෙන ලෝකෙට හඳුන්වා දෙන්න. ඒ අනුව අපිට අධ්‍යන කාර්ය මණ්ඩලයක් පුහුණු විශේෂයෙන්ම පශ්චාත් උපාධි ඒ විශාල විශේෂට අදාළ පශ්චාත් උපාධි හදාරලා නියමිත පුහුණුවක් ලබාගත් අධ්‍යන කාර්ය මණ්ඩලයක් සෛද්ධාන්තික කටයුතු, සායනික කටයුතු, ප්‍රායෝගික කටයුතු, ඒ වගේම පර්යේෂණ කටයුතු වල දැනුම ලබා දීමට කටයුතු කරනවා. ඒ සඳහා ඔබ වාසනාව ලබා ගන්නවා එවන් පිස්සකගෙන් ඒ දැනුම ලබා ගැනීමට. ඒ නිසා ඔබ සියලු දෙනාටම අද සිදලා විශාල කාර්යභාරයක් තිබෙනවා. මේ පාඨමාලාව හරියාකාරව හදාරලා ඒ අනුව නිසි ආකාරව ඒ ආයුර්වේද හෝ යුනානි උපාධිය ලබා ගැනීම. ඒ වගේම ඔබ සියලු දෙනාම දැනගන්න ඕන අධ්‍යන කටයුතු පමණක් නෙවෙයි අනිකුත් නිපුණතා නායකත්ව නිපුණතා දියුණු කර ගැනීමටත් මෙම ආයතනය තුලින් ඉඩකඩ ලබා දී තිබෙනවා. අප කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට සම්බන්ධව අනුබද්ධව වැඩ කරන ආයතනයක් බැවින් ඔබට ඒ සඳහා ඒ තියෙන සියලුම පහසුකම් ලබා ගැනීමට උපකුල තුමියගේ උපදෙස් පරිදි අපිට හැකියාව ලැබෙනවා. මා ඉංග්‍රීසි මාතෙන් කිව්ව ආකාරයටම මතක් කිරීමට කැමති මෙම ආයතනයේ සුවිශේෂී පසුගිය වසර දෙක තුලම නවක වදය සම්බන්ධයෙන් කිසිම පැමිණිල්ලක් ලැබිලා නැති ආයතනයක්. ඒ සඳහා මට උදව් උපකාර කර අපේ ජේෂ්ඨ ශිෂ්‍යයින් අධ්‍යන අනාත්‍යන ඒ වගේම පරිපාලන කාර්ය මණ්ඩලය මා තාමත් පුතක්තුරුව වෙනවා ඒ වගේ වාතාවරණයක් ඇති කිරීමට හැකියාව. මේ සම්බන්ධව අපිට සාක්ෂි දන්නවා 2017-18 වසරේ සම්බන්ධ සිසුන් 18-19 වසරේ සම්බන්ධ සිසුන් ඒ අය තත්. ඒ නිසා ඔබලාට කිසිම හැකියාවක් සිදුවෙන්නේ නැහැ. මේ කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනයේ පැමිණි තමන්ගේ අධ්‍යන කටයුතු සාර්ථකව කරගෙන යෑමට හැකියාව ඇති වාතාවරණයක් ලැබිලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් මේ අනුව ඔබ සියලු දෙනාම සතුටු විය යුතුයි. So with that I conclude my speech. I welcome all of you to this Institute of Indigenous Medicine and wish you all the best for your future aspirations. Thank you very much.
பணிப்பாளர் அவர்களின் உரையின் சுருக்கத்தை தமிழில் தருவதில் மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகின்றேன். 237 மாணவர்களை இணையதளம் வாயிலாக காண்பதில் மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகின்றார் தொடர்ந்து உங்களுக்குரிய வகுப்புகள் இணையதளம் மூலம் நடைபெறும் எங்கள் இலக்கு நாட்டுக்கும் நாட்டு மக்களுக்கும் சிறந்த ஆயுர்வேத மற்றும் யுனானி மருத்துவர்களை உருவாக்குவதாகும் இது உங்களுடைய பல்கலைக்கழக வாழ்க்கை பாடசாலை வாழ்க்கையை விட வித்தியாசமானது ஆனால் இது பகடிவதையற்ற சுதந்திரமான ஒரு வளாகம் இதற்காக அனைத்து விரிவுரையாளர்களும் துணை நிற்பார்கள் உங்களது உயர்கல்வியுடன் நீங்கள் காணொலியில் கண்டுகளித்த அனைத்து துறைகளிலும் உங்களை ஈடுபடுத்தி தேர்ச்சி பெற்ற ஆயுர்வேத மற்றும் யுனானி மருத்துவர்களை உருவாக்கும் எமது உள்நாட்டு மருத்துவ நிறுவகம் ஆயுர்வேத போதனா வைத்தியசாலையுடன் இணைந்துள்ளதால் நீங்கள் உங்களது பயிற்சிகளை அங்கே பெற்றுக்கொள்ளலாம் பெற்றோர்களே உங்கள் பிள்ளைகள் இன்று உள்நாட்டு மருத்துவ நிறுவகத்தில் காலடி எடுத்து வைத்துள்ளார்கள் உங்களுடன் நான் தனியான சந்திப்பை வைத்து உரையாடுவேன் என பணிப்பாளர் அவர்கள் கூறுகிறார்கள் உங்கள் எதிர்கால முன்னேற்றத்தை நோக்கி வீர நடை போட்டு உயர்ந்த இலக்குகளை எய்த முயற்சிக்குமாறு வாழ்த்தி விடை பெறுகின்றார் நன்றி
Thank you very much. It was the Tamil translation of Madam Director's speech. And thank you very much, Madam Director of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Senior Professor Priyani A. Farnagama, for delivering the welcome note. Next up is another valuable address. Her Excellencies in experienced administration with enlightenment in knowledge, responsiveness, attention is a remarkable driven empowerment to the generation to proceed. As the preceding force of the development of the motherland and even to the entire world. University of Colombo, which is ranking in first among the Sri Lankan universities, became a reality behind the assistance of this courageous personality. I kindly invite the Vice Chancellor of the University of Colombo, Senior Professor Chandrika N. Vijayaratne, to address the gathering. Madam, it's over to you.
Ayubovan, thank you very much for those very generous words of introduction. Madam Director, all the heads of academic staff, as well as all the academics, administrators, and support staff of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, and the senior student counselor, Dr. Rajita De Silva. On behalf of all of us, I wish to congratulate each and every student who has joined the BAMS and the BUMS courses of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine of our university. So on behalf of the University of Colombo, I wish to congratulate you and your parents, friends, and family who must be absolutely thrilled that you gained admission to the best of the universities, the best university in Sri Lanka, the University of Colombo. Many congratulations also to the fact that each and every one of you have committed yourselves for the rest of your lives to be in the process of helping others in their illnesses, helping others beyond yourself to remain healthy in body and mind. So no doubt all of you have gained entrance through the A-level 2019 process through the UGC. And I am very much aware that you all have gone through a lot of delays in terms of not due to COVID-19, but other issues in gaining entry into university. And I pledge that we would take every measure to ensure that you do not get delayed in your higher educational process in the coming years. I am very much aware and conscious of the fact that each and every one of you have had problems to face due to the ongoing pandemic. But nevertheless, like what Madam Director said, it is very noteworthy that the majority, over 97%, have registered and been joined online to the digital mode today at this time. As Madam Paranagama said, we do not want any student to be left behind. So there is no doubt about it that these recordings of these proceedings would be made available to all of you and your parents, and particularly to find out why those few students could not join the proceedings today. As you know, we are over 1 year in living and working and learning with COVID-19, a tiny virus that has plagued the world and changed our entire function, outlook, and priorities. So while you young people, our future generation, the future of this university, have had to cope, I'm sure your parents, well-wishers, as much as the higher education authorities of Sri Lanka, have had your best interests at heart to make sure that today happened as it is happening now. So no doubt you have to get adjusted to university life. You are no longer in school. You are no longer in a tutory. You are no longer only at home, but no doubt linking with home and your own areas, you have joined a great university. You are now an adult learner, and your learning process, no doubt the word teaching is important, but learning is much more important. So you need to be able to grasp the fundamentals of all these philosophies and principles of practice that your lecturers would take you and guide you throughout in the coming years. No doubt there will be very hard and challenging times in the learning process, but I'm sure every one of you, if you have the will, can overcome those obstacles despite the digital divide and be able to come out shining brightly. I must state that the Indigenous Medicine, this particular institute being 92 years old, is unique. The major part of the University of Colombo in terms of science and arts just celebrated 100 years. The medical faculty celebrated 150 years last year. But nevertheless, you all are not far behind. So yours is a very mature and a unique institute, because we are talking about homegrown issues, homegrown principles, philosophies to benefit humankind. But no doubt there is a science in it, and therefore you need to be a multifaceted personality, a multifaceted and committed and responsible professional in terms of being a learner, a practitioner, as well as a well-rounded, civic-minded citizen of Sri Lanka. As you know, very recently, the 16th university was formed for Indigenous Medicine at the Vikramarachchi Institute in Gampaha, which has now been converted into a university. But IIM, the staff and the students opted to remain with the University of Colombo, and for that, I'm very grateful and humbled. You all need to appreciate that this institute, which is taped to become a standalone faculty in the very near future, would need to take in its stride good discipline, a very student-friendly environment, quality standards being maintained, and the main focus to be to work with honesty and integrity to help our fellow men who are in need of healthcare, but aligned with what the healthcare systems of Sri Lanka offer today. So university life is very different to school. You need to learn lots of new aspects: teamwork, leadership, freedom of thought, freedom of expression, but at the same time, honor the disciplinary rules and regulations. And like what Madam Paranagama stated, we have been zero ragging in the IIM, for which I think I am very proud to say it, that the university is very conscious about. One main reason is that from your point of entry, you are being well cared for by your very committed staff who lead the staff-oriented orientation course, staff-guided orientation course, and also with the multiple inputs of discipline and good functionality in terms of fairness, transparency, accountability, and justice. So ragging is a word that we do not entertain at all. If there is even any form of a whiff of bullying, ragging, sexual harassment, the University of Colombo has prioritized that we shall not have any form of tolerance. Because we are all here to learn and help society, as we all know that we are funded by public funds. Funds are very short these days, particularly with COVID-19 and its economic impact. But I must state that we are still forging ahead. We have been able to take in your new batch and try to catch up in whatever delays that you have experienced due to reasons beyond our control. So we need to value all these and function with level of independence, but also mutual trust, and also appreciate that diversity, vividatvaya, is so important. Only from that aspect that we learn to become good professionals, good carers, where our parents, our friends, our communities would be very proud of that their kith and kin, their products, their schools have produced such wonderful Ayurvedic and Unani health practitioners. So I'm sure you will have lots of things to learn, from IT to learning on your own, independent thought processes rather than just rote learning and vomiting it out at an exam, and also being able to apply your knowledge at the bedside with your patient. I must also say that there is a postgraduate institute of indigenous medicine, which is with Colombo and working closely with IIM. So there is a career path, there is an academic path well paved out for you through this very mature and wonderful organization. So make the best of it. As Madam said, improve your soft skills through art, drama, fine arts, media, and of course sports. Sports has become a bit of a problem these days, except those that we can do on digital mode. But no doubt, I'm sure you all will have a very fulfilling experience, and may you be happy, prosperous, and highly learned products of our university who can reach for the stars while your feet remain on the ground. Thank you so much, and all the very best to you. Aiboa.
Thank you very much, Madam Senior Professor Priyani A. Paral, Senior Professor Chandrika N. Vijayaratna, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Colombo, for your valuable, experienced, informative, and guiding speech to adults. Let me, for the Sinhala translation of that special speech. කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලීය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යායතනය BAMS සහ BUMS අධ්‍යන පාඨමාලාවන් ඔබ වෙත ලබා දෙනු ළමයි. එම පාඨමාලාවන් සඳහා අද දින සුසඳන ඔබ සැමට මාගේ ගෞරවනීය වගේම ආදරණීය සුභාශිංසනය එක්කරමු ලබනවා. ඒට හේතුව වන්නේ කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලීය මෙරට හොඳම විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය වශයෙන් ඔබගේ ජීවිතයේ ඉදිරියේ සාර්ථකත්වයට උර දෙන බැවින් ඔබේ ජීවිතයේ ඉදිරිය අන් අයගේ කායික මානසික සුවතාවය වෙනුවෙනුත් ඔවුන්ගේ සතුට වෙනුවෙනුත් ඔබ කැපකිරීමට සූදානමින් අද දින මෙම පාඨමාලාවන් සඳහා එක්වනු ලබනවා ඒ පිළිබඳව ඔබට මාගේ සුභාශිංසන. අධ්‍යන පොදු සහතික පත්‍ර උසස් පෙළ විභාගයෙන් අනතුරුව විවිධ බාධා හමුවේ යම් යම් පමාවීම් හමුවේ ඔබ අද මෙම විශ්වවිද්‍යාල ප්‍රවිෂ්ඨය ආරම්භ කරන අවස්ථාවේදී කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය මගින් මෙතෙන් පටන් ඔබට කිසිදු පමාවකින් තොරව ඔබගේ අධ්‍යන කටයුතු නිසි පරිදි ඉටු කර ගැනීමට අවශ්‍ය පරිසරය නිති ලබා දෙනු ඇත. ඒ වගේම පවත්නා තත්ත්වය හමුවේ මාර්ගගත ක්‍රමයට සිදුවන අධ්‍යාපනික ක්‍රියාවලිය සාර්ථකව සිදු කර ගැනීම සඳහා ශිෂ්‍යයන් වෙත අවශ්‍ය සියලු පසුබිම කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය මගින් ඉතා සතුටින් සම්පාදනය කර දෙන ලබයි. පුරා වසරකට ආසන්න කාලයක් COVID-19 වසංගත තත්ත්වය හමුවේ මෙම බාරගුණ කාර්යයට උර දෙන කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ඔබගේ අනාගත අභිවෘද්ධිය උදෙසා උපරිම කැපවීම දක්වන ලබනවා. අද දින සාර්ථකත්වය තව දුරටත් තහවුරු වන්නේ අනාගතයේ ඔබ තුළ ඇති අධිෂ්ඨානශීලීත්වයත් කැපවීමත් තුලින්. ඔබ වයසින් මුහුකුරා ගිය ශිෂ්‍යයෙක්. එබැවින් විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය තුලින් ඔබට ලබා දෙන අවස්ථාවන් හොඳින් ප්‍රයෝජනෙට ගනිමින් අධ්‍යාපනය මෙන්ම විනයානුකූල වූත් ඉතා ප්‍රශස්ත වූත් සේවයක් අවසානයේ රටටත් ලෝකයටත් ලබා දීම ඔබේ වගකීම වෙනවා. මෙය අභියෝගාත්මක අවස්ථාවක්. නමුත් කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේ මෙම පාඨමාලාවන් හැදෑරීම අවසානයේ එය ඔබටත් රටටත් ආලෝකයක් ගෙන දෙනු ඇත. වසර 90ක් පුරාවට ඉතිහාසයේ කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යායතනය කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට අවශ්‍ය සියලුම සේවාවන් ඉතා හොඳින් පවත්වා ගනිමින් රටට වැඩදායි විද්‍යාර්ථීන් බිහි කිරීමෙහිලා උත්සුක වූයේ විවිධ පරාසයන් තුළ විහිද ගිය දැනුමින් යුතු ශිෂ්‍යයෙකු ලෙස එමෙන්ම මෙරටට හොඳ පුරවැසියෙකු ලෙස සිය අධ්‍යාපනය මෙහෙවා ගැනීමේ ඔබේ වගකීම ඔබ ඉතා හොඳින් ඉටු කරනු ඇතැයි මම අපේක්ෂා කරනවා. කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට අනුපත්ිත ආයතනයක් ලෙස කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනය එදා මෙදා තුර පවත්වාගෙන ආ උසස් ප්‍රමිතීන්ගෙන් යුතු අවංකත්වය සහ විශ්වාසනීයත්වය රකිමින් තවදුරටත් සෞඛ්‍ය ක්ෂේත්‍ර ප්‍රවර්ධනයට අවශ්‍ය කටයුතු ඔබ වෙනුවෙන් ඉදිරිපත් කර ප්‍රසම්පාදනය කරනවා. ඒ සඳහා කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය මගින් ලබා දෙන සහයෝගය ඔබ මැනවින් පරිහරණය කරනු ඇතැයි මා විශ්වාස කරනවා. ඉතා හොඳ විනය පවත්වාගෙන යන කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල පරිශ්‍රය තුළ දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනය විශේෂ වන්නේ මෙය නවක වදය සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම තුලන් කළ භූමියක් ලෙසයි. කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ අරමුණු හා සම්බන්ධ වෙමින් නවක වදය හෝ ඒ ආශ්‍රිත ක්‍රියාවන් සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය තුලින් ඉවත් කිරීමට ගත් උත්සාහයේ ප්‍රතිඵලයට දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යායතනයද සිය සහයෝගය උපරිම වශයෙන් ලබා දී තිබෙනවා. මේ අනුව කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ අනුදැනුම මත කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනය ඔබට මේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට ප්‍රවිෂ්ඨ වෙන අද දිනේ පටන් සුරක්ෂිත වටපිටාවක් තුළ විධිමත් අධ්‍යාපනයක් ලබා දීමට අවශ්‍ය පසුබිම නොතික්ව ලබා දෙනු ඇත. එසේනම් ආයුර්වේද වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාවේ සහ යුනානි වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාවේ පරිපූර්ණ දැනුමකින් යුතු පරිණත දැනුමත් අතික්‍රමණය කර ගනිමින් ඔබේ අධ්‍යාපනය ඉතා හොඳින් පවත්වාගෙන යනු ඇතැයි මා අපේක්ෂා කරනවා. ඒ සඳහා අවශ්‍ය දැනුමින් සන්නද්ධිත විධිමත් ආචාර්ය මණ්ඩලයක් සහ අධ්‍යන මණ්ඩලයක් කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය මෙන්ම දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේද සතුව පවතිනවා. එහි අග්‍රඵලයේ ඔබ නෙලා ගනිමින් විවිධ හැකියාවන් වලින් පරිපූර්ණිත වූ ඔබගේ නිපුණත්වයන් තවදුරටත් දියුණු කර ගනිමින් විධිමත් අධ්‍යාපන රටාවක් තුළ එදා මෙදා තුර කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ගැන ආ ඒ සාර්ථකත්වයට ඔබත් එක් වේයි අපේක්ෂා කරන අතරතුර එම අධ්‍යාපනයේ සාර්ථකත්වය මගින් මේ රටට වැඩදායී පුරවැසියෙකු ලෙස ඔබ සේවය කරතයි මා අපේක්ෂා කර සිටිනවා. කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ කුලපති චන්ද්‍රිකා ජ්‍යෙෂ්ඨ මහාචාර්ය චන්ද්‍රිකායන් විජිරත්න මැතිතුමිය විසින් වර්ෂ 2019-2020 අධ්‍යන වර්ෂයේ දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනයේ සරසවි ප්‍රවිෂ්ටිය වෙනුවෙන් පැවැත්වූ සභා මන්ත්‍රණයේ සංක්ෂිප්ත සිංහල පරිවර්තනය අවසන්. ස්තුතියි.
கொழும்பு பல்கலைக்கழக உபவேந்தர் அவர்களின் உரையின் சுருக்கத்தை தமிழில் தருவதில் மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகின்றேன். இலங்கையின் உயர்தர பல்கலைக்கழகத்தில் உங்களுக்கு அனுமதி கிடைத்ததையிட்டு மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகின்றேன். உங்கள் உயர்கல்வியை தாமதமின்றி முடிப்பதற்கு வசதிகள் செய்து தருவதாக உறுதியளிக்கின்றேன். நாங்கள் COVID-19 வைரசுடன் ஒரு வருடமாக வாழ்ந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறோம். ஆனாலும் தாமதமின்றி உங்கள் உயர்கல்வியை தொடர அனைத்து வசதிகளையும் இவர்கள் செய்து தந்துள்ளார்கள். ஆகவே நீங்கள் அனைவரும் தடைகளை தாண்டி ஆயுர்வேத மற்றும் யுனானி அடிப்படைகளை கற்றுத்தேறி சிறந்த ஆயுர்வேத மற்றும் யுனானி மருத்துவர்களாக வர வேண்டும். இலங்கையில் உள்நாட்டு மருத்துவ நிறுவகம் ஒரு தனித்துவமான நிறுவகம். இதில் கல்வி கற்று நீங்கள் நல்ல மருத்துவர்களாகவும் நாட்டுக்கு நட்புரஜைகளாகவும் வர வாழ்த்துகிறேன். மேலும் அவர் தெரிவிக்கையில், ஒழுக்கமுள்ள தன்னம்பிக்கையுள்ள மாணவர்களை உருவாக்குவதே எமது கொழும்பு பல்கலைக்கழகத்தின் நோக்கம். எனவே அதனை எதிர்காலத்தில் நடைமுறைப்படுத்துவீர்கள் என நான் எதிர்பார்க்கின்றேன். தகுதி வாய்ந்த மற்றும் விளக்கமளிக்கும் முறையை நிகழ்த்தி சென்ற மேன்மைமிகு உபவேந்தர் அவர்களுக்கு நன்றிகள். இக்கடினமான நிலைமையிலும் எங்களோடு கலந்து சிறப்பித்தமை உள்நாட்டு மருத்துவத்துறையில் அவர் உன்னாட்டு மருத்துவத்துறையை அவர் ஊக்குவிப்பதை விளக்குகின்றது.
Thank you very much everyone. It was the address of the Vice Chancellor of the University of Colombo, Senior Professor Chandrika and Vijayaratna, and the Sinhala and Tamil translations of the respective speech. One dream, one destination, different communities, different cultures, different concepts, exactly endeavor challenges in the new journey that you all are starting from today. The step towards the goal with success is comfortable only with the accurate and timely guidance which are already empowered in the University of Colombo with the commendable assistance of the Senior Students Counselor. So let me invite Senior Lecturer Dr. Rajita Silva to address the orientation program of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Very good morning to all of you. With the permission of Senior Professor Chandrika N. Vijayaratna, Vice Chancellor, University of Colombo, and Director IIM, Senior Professor Mrs. Parnagama, and all other academic as well as non-academic staff, and my dear students. I would like to speak a few words about your studentship as well as how you can proceed with university life. First of all, I would like to welcome you all to the University of Colombo on behalf of all the student counselors of the university, as well as on behalf of all the student counselors of IIM. Then there are certain mechanisms actually we have placed inside the university as student counselors to make sure that you all are having very supportive and conducive learning environment to complete your complete education and also to make you a holistic academician. Then at the end, what we want is like you all to complete your degree programs on time and deliver your valuable services, which are very needed services at the moment, to the society as well as the country, Sri Lanka. In this regards, now there are certain supporting services, as I mentioned, now we are undertaking. As Vice Chancellor, as well as your director indicated, now this is very challenging period. During this particular period, taking education, especially education through online platforms, not going to be that easy. As long as our experience, there are students like who are experiencing certain difficulties, especially like it is amounted to student related stress, academic matters, and also other subsequent questions and issues. Then as student counselors, we are always open to you where that we can provide maximum support within our capacity. You all need to understand this is a state university. And there are different rules, regulations, and especially the norms, because you all are going to be medical practitioners one day. And you also, your value is very important for us as well as the country. Therefore, I mean, you have to operate within the platform of these valued systems, which are inherited from University of Colombo. Over the years, your senior academics, as well as senior students, I mean, who all respected those and established very valuable kind of behavior and the learning environment. As we are very closely working with all your senior students, as well as academics, one thing I can give you as a guarantee, as even Vice Chancellor mentioned, now there are no ragging at all. Then this is going to be a very good news for your parents as well. Therefore, like what you need to do now is to make sure that you are a holistic learner. And another couple of years time, you are going to be graduates of this university. Now on that day, if you can be proud about what you have achieved, now this is the most important thing. And also, from today onwards, as registered students of University of Colombo, you all are equals to us. There are no demarcations, no differences. You all are having the same rights. And also you have to make sure your rights are enjoying as well as same time you are protecting others' rights as well. It may be senior or junior, doesn't make any difference to us. Then as I mentioned, now there are certain mechanisms. Now you have a couple of marshals, I mean, who are already deployed in your institute. And also there are marshals like who are operating from the central camp university. Then whenever necessary, like we are working together, time to time we visit your places and you also can come to main premises and get your services. You can enjoy the library facilities and things. And also, even last time I can remember, we introduced certain opportunities that you have, such as we have very strong LEO movement, where a lot of students, I mean, who are engaged and they are getting certain experiences in terms of leadership, relationship. Now, how do you behave with community, corporates and all. And also same time, we have Rotaract Club, where that you can become a member of them. And also importantly, we have Gavel Club. And not only that, ISAC, and like that, I mean, there are so many different platforms for you to develop yourself. And also as a medical practitioners in future, now your exposure to do all these things would be very, very important and vital. And also, as I mentioned, marshals are working with us in order to take care of your discipline. And other thing is welfare. Now, our university, we have student and staff welfare unit, which is directly working with us and coordinating all the facilities and different scholarships which are available to our students. And we try our best, as Madam Vice Chancellor mentioned, within the limited resources, but maximum coverage that we are giving. I can remember last time where there was this pandemic related matter, like Madam Vice Chancellor initiated providing all the online units, facilities, as well as these different devices to students now who are experiencing difficulties. And also our alumni and all other outside stakeholders. Now they are providing the maximum support for us to make sure entire student community of University of Colombo, irrespective of the faculty, irrespective of the institute, having the best environment in Sri Lanka for their education. And also same time, I wanted to tell you a couple of other things as well. I think our handbook already shared with you on e-form, and also all the contact details and everything is available. Understand this is going to be a bureaucratic organization. Why I'm saying it? Because it is a governmental structure. Now, therefore, now if you're approaching, like, I mean, you have to understand the way to communicate. Then you have immediate teachers with you, right? And also, like, I mean, if you have any kind of an issue that you can discuss with your teachers, I'm pretty sure now they are always very supportive and they are open to you all the time. And also each and every department, now you have student counselors. Now they are also like very much open to you, and I have shared all their contact details in that particular booklet, where that you can contact all of them as necessary. Then I know for sure, without any problem, I can give you a guarantee, you have a wonderful head of departments as well as a director who is always open for you. Anytime you can approach, it may be daytime as well as nighttime, nothing to worry. Then you have the contact details of us, where, like, I mean, in the handbook it is available, and also in the chat I have just mentioned the hotline of a student counselor's office, which is 24 hours for your service. If you have any difficulty, then you can contact us. Then please understand, first priority, your institute, your teachers, your student counselors. Then if you need further assistance, like, you can come up with. Then we have special services to provide you certain well-being as well as mental welfare related concerns. And we have well experienced counselors, like, if you have any kind of psychological issues, and you can approach to us, right? Anytime you can visit, like, I mean, after all these pandemics related stories, and you can enjoy with us. And we'll be providing the maximum support. And also, there are certain other concerns. Then in university, we have certain disciplinary procedures. Now today you are brand new students to us. But tomorrow that you are going to be senior student. Then please make sure, like, I mean, everybody having same right to go ahead with their education. In university, now we have certain rules and regulations and special disciplinary procedures and special punishment systems, right? Who are violating acceptable discipline, who is disturbing complete education system of university as well as faculties. Then we will be making sure that you are aware of all these. And also, as Madam Vice Chancellor mentioned, ragging is not an unacceptable practice. It is an offense in front of the legal system of Sri Lanka. A maximum punishment would be 12 years. Now I'm telling you because now today as new students, like, you are under some sort of peer pressure because of Sri Lankan university perception. But tomorrow that you all are going to be senior students, then therefore, like, I mean, you have to keep all these things in mind. And also as an institute, as well as part of our university, IIM is a very nice place for your education, and you can complete your education successfully. Thank you so much, and we will be wishing you all the best for your entire academic career with us. Anytime you can contact us. You all are welcome to be with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir. Colombo Vishwavidyalaye Jeshtha Shishya Upadeshaka Jeshtha Kathikacharya Rajakita Silva Mathuthuman oba hamuwe gena a kathanaye Sinhala bhasha parivartanaya. Colombo Vishwavidyalaye magin obage tritiya adhyapanaya kramavatva pavathwa gena yamata darana utsahayata
අද දින ඔබ නවක ශිෂ්‍යයෙකු ලෙස අපහා එක් වුණා. ඒ පිළිබඳව ප්‍රථමයෙන් මාගේ සුභාශිංසනය. කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ජ්‍යෙෂ්ඨ ශිෂ්‍ය උපදේශක ලෙස විවිධ නීති රීති සහ ගුණාංග තුලින් විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ උසස් ප්‍රමිතීන් ආරක්ෂා කර ගැනීමටත් ශිෂ්‍ය සුභ සාධනය මනාව පවත්වා ගැනීමටත් අප විශාල මෙහෙයක යෙදෙනවා. විශේෂයෙන්ම පරිපූර්ණ දේශීය වෛද්‍යවරයෙකු ලෙස ඔබ තුල මෙම ගුණාංගයන් පවත්වා ගනු ඇතයි මා අපේක්ෂා කරනවා. එමගින් වටිනා සේවයක් සමාජයට ලබා දීමට ඔබට හැකිවනු ඇත. ඒ සඳහා අවශ්‍ය පසුබිම කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය මගින් නිරන්තරයෙන් සපයා දෙනු ලබනවා. විශේෂයෙන්ම විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ උපකුලපතිතුමියන් පැවසූ පරිදි නවක වදයෙන් තොර පරිසරයක් තුළ ඔබගේ විධිමත් අධ්‍යාපනය අඛණ්ඩව පවත්වාගෙන යාමට කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ඔබට අවශ්‍ය ඕනෑම මොහොතක අවශ්‍ය සියලු කටයුතු සම්පාදනය කර දෙනු ලබනවා. එමෙන්ම ඔබට මෙහි සෑම ශිෂ්‍යයෙකු හා සම වූ අයිතීන් තියෙනවා. මෙම අයිතීන් සුරක්ෂිත කර ගැනීමට කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ලෙස එහි සමස්ත ආචාර්ය මණ්ඩලයත් අධ්‍යන සහ අනර්ථකාරී මණ්ඩලයේ සියලුම දෙනාත් නිරන්තරයෙන් කැප වී සිටිනවා. එය ඔබ එකිනෙකා අතර මනාමානව සම්බන්ධතාවයන් පවත්වා ගැනීම තුළින් විවිධ අත්දැකීම් විවිධ සමාජ සන්දර්භයන් තුළින් ඔබ ගෙන ආ පසුබිම්හි සාර්ථක ප්‍රතිඵලයක් අත්කර ගැනීමට ඉවහල් වනු ඇත. සැබවින්ම වෛද්‍ය වෘත්තිකයෙකු ලෙස එය ඉතා වැදගත්. ශිෂ්‍ය සුබ සාධනය පිළිබඳ සලකා බැලීමේදී ඔබට විවිධ අවස්ථාවන් සලසා දෙමින් විවිධ ශිෂ්‍යාධාර සහ මාර්ගෝපදේශනයන් සඳහා අවශ්‍ය පසුබිම් සකසා දෙමින් ඔබගේ සුබ සාධනය ලබා දීමට කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය ලෙස අපි නොපැකිලව මෙතිහත් වෙනවා. විශේෂයෙන්ම දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යායතනයේ අධ්‍යක්ෂකතුමිය ප්‍රමුඛ ආචාර්ය මණ්ඩලය දිවා රාත්‍රී භේදයකින් තොරව ඔබට අවශ්‍ය ඕනෑම මොහොතක ඔබගේ ඕනෑම ගැටලුවක් ඔබගේ ඕනෑම අවශ්‍යතාවයක් නිරන්තරයෙන් දැන ගැනීම සඳහා නිරන්තරයෙන් ඔබ වෙනුවෙන් සේවා සපයනවා. විශේෂයෙන්ම විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ශිෂ්‍ය උපදේශකයන් ඔබට අවශ්‍ය ඕනෑම මොහොතක දුරකථන සම්බන්ධතා ඔස්සේ සම්බන්ධ කර ගැනීමෙන් ඔබගේ ගැටලු निराකරණය කර ගැනීමේ අවස්ථාව ඔබට පවතිනවා. එසේනම් මෙම වත්මනෙහි පවතින කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ප්‍රශස්ත මානව දයාවෙන් යුතු විනයානුකූල සහ විශිෂ්ට අධ්‍යාපන පරිසරයකින් යුතු මෙම තත්ත්වය අඛණ්ඩව පවත්වා ගනිමින් ඔබ විධිමත් අධ්‍යාපනයේ ප්‍රතිඵල ලබා ගනු ඇතැයි මා අපේක්ෂා කර සිටින අතර ඒ සඳහා ඔබට අපගේ සුභාශිංසනද එකතු කරනවා. කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ජ්‍යෙෂ්ඨ ශිෂ්‍ය උපදේශක ජ්‍යෙෂ්ඨ කථිකාචාර්ය රජිතද සිල්වා මැතිතුමන් විසින් සභාව ආමන්ත්‍රණය කළ එම කතාවේ සංක්ෂිප්ත සිංහල පරිවර්තනය අවසන්. ස්තුතියි.
කොළඹ පල්කලකම් ශ්‍රේෂ්ඨ මානව ආලෝසகரின் உரையின் சுருக்கம் இதோ. நாங்கள் மிகவும் சவாலான காலகட்டத்தில் இருந்து கொண்டிருக்கின்றோம். உங்கள் சவால்களை தாண்டி முன்னேறி செல்ல தேவையான எல்லா வசதிகளையும் நாம் செய்து தருவோம். ஆனால் நீங்கள் பல்கலைக்கழக கட்டுப்பாடுகளுக்கு கட்டுப்பட்டு நடக்க வேண்டும். இங்கு சீனியர் ஜூனியர் என்ற வேறுபாடில்லை. நீங்கள் பகுதிவடைவதையற்ற ஒரு வளாகத்தில் உள்ளீர்கள். உங்கள் உரிமைகளையும் மற்றவர்களின் உரிமைகளையும் மதித்து நடக்க வேண்டும். நாங்கள் எங்களால் முடிந்த உதவிகளையும் தேவைகளையும் வழங்குவதற்காக நலன்புரி சேவைகளையும் வழங்குகின்றோம். இவற்றை கொண்டு நல்ல ஒழுக்கமுள்ள வைத்தியர்களாக உருவாக வாழ்த்துகின்றேன். உங்களுக்கான அறிவுரைகளை இணையதளம் வாயிலாக தொடர்பு ஒன்று நீங்கள் பெற்றுக்கொள்ளலாம். எப்போதும் சுதந்திரமாக இருந்து கட்கை நெறிகளை நல்ல முறையில் நடாத்தி சென்று நாட்டுக்கும் உலகிற்கும்
திறமையான சிறந்த ஒழுக்கமுள்ள மருத்துவர்களாக உருவாக எனது வாழ்த்துக்கள். நன்றி.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rajita Silva, the Senior Students Counselor of the University of Colombo, for delivering the speech. And thank you for the Sinhala and Tamil translations. Madam, your address will be a mirror for all of our new students to see their dreams. Your personal commitment, the personality, the determination, expressiveness, and attitudes raise the newer healers step by step to the success. I would like to invite the head of the Department of Study of Ayurveda, Senior Lecturer, Dr. S.P. Mohanvada, to address the gallery.
Thank you very much. Aibowan, Vanakkam, Assalamualaikum, Madam Vice Chancellor, University of Colombo, Senior Professor Chandrika Vijayaratna, Madam Director IIM, Senior Professor Priyani Paranagama, Chief Student Counselor, University of Colombo, Dr. Rajita D. Silva, Head of the Yunnan Section, Professor M.S.M. Shifa, Register IIM, Mr. Lalit Varnasuriya, Security Consultant of the IIM, Senior Assistant Counsel, Student Counselor IIM, Dr. Anoma Samaravikrama, all the professors, academic members, and non-academic members of the institute, parents, and my dear student. Today is a very special day for you. As we are enrolling new student to 2019-2020 batch, Ayurveda as well as Yunani, this step which you all are starting from now is a very significant point of your life. From now on, you are starting your professional time period as an Ayurveda and Yunani student. Of course, there will be difficulties, challenges, but you should be strong enough to face all those things. As lecturers, as teachers, not only that, as mentors, we are there for you to give your help hand when you need us. So we hope the journey you begin from today will give you a bright future, and we wish you to learn well and to be a good Ayurveda and Yunani physician in near future. Children, please keep in your mind this 5 years of time which is given to you by the government with free education is to learn and to be a good citizen. So don't waste time for unnecessary things. Finally, I welcome you all to this occasion. Thank you very much. Dayabara Darudaryani, Demapiyavaruni, Mahitane, other Deshiya Vaidya Vidyayatanator, Itamat Saturdayaka Dinaya, Vedas Dahanamaya, Vedas Visa Adyanavarshe Sandaha, Ayurveda Saha Yunani, Adhyapana Patamalavan Hadari in the Sandaha, Oba Adadina Sita, Mema Ayatanator, Pravishtavina. Evagema, Pasalim Nikmila, Vishwidyala Adhyapane Kara Yomuena Adapalavini Davasa, Shishek Vashen, Evagema Anagata Burtiya Divye, Sandhistanya, Arambaka Pivarak Vashen, ඔබ අද මේ ආරම්භ කරන ගමන විවිධ අභියෝගතා විවිධ දුෂ්කරතා වලින් පිරි කාලවකවානුවක් විය හැකි එය පාසල් දිවිය හා සමකල නොහැකි එනමුත් ඒ සියලුම දේට නිර්භීතව ඒ අභියෝග ජය ගනිමින් ගමන් කිරීමට තමන්ගේ සාර්ථක අවසානය දක්වා ගමන් කිරීමට ඔබ සැමට හැකි වෙන බව මා දන්නවා ඒ ධෛර්යය ඔබ සතුකල ගත යුතුයමයි එමෙන්ම නිදහස් අධ්‍යාපනයේ තුලින් ඔබට මේ ලබා දී ඇති අවස්ථාව ඉතාමත් අනගි අවස්ථාවක් විශ්වවිද්‍යාල අධ්‍යාපනය හැමෝටම නොලැබෙන වාසනාවන්ත පිරිසකට අත්පත් වෙන අවස්ථාවක් වන අතර එම අධ්‍යාපනය විවිධ අනවශ්‍ය දේවල් වලට කාලය යොමු නොකරමින් එම අධ්‍යාපනයේ සියලුම ඵල සාර්ථකව අත්පත් කර ගැනීම යහපත් රටට වැඩදායි ආයුර්වේද වෛද්‍යවරේ ඒ වගේම යුනානි වෛද්‍යරේ වීමට අදිස්ථාන කරගන්න ඒ වගේම අද දින සිට මේ ආරම්භ කරන ඔබගේ වෘත්තීය දිවිය ඉතාමත් සාර්ථක වේවා කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ හෙවණැල්ල ලැබමින් මේ ආරම්භ කරන විශ්වවිද්‍යාල ශිෂ්‍ය ජීවිතය ඉතාමත් සාර්ථක වේවායි ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරමි ඔබ සියලු දෙනාටම නිදුක් ආරක්ෂාකාරී දිවියක් ලැබේවායි ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරමි මම සමුගන්නවා ස්තුතියි
ஆயுர்வேத பிரிவின் தலைவி உங்கள் அனைவரையும் வரவேற்று வாழ்த்து தெரிவிப்பதில் பெரும் மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகிறார் மேலும் இன்று உங்கள் வாழ்வில் உங்கள் எதிர்காலத்துக்கும் உயர்கல்விக்குமான முக்கியமான ஆரம்பமாகும் இதன் போதே பலவிதமான கஷ்டங்கள் இடையூறுகள் வந்தாலும் துணிச்சலுடன் முகம் கொடுக்க வேண்டும் இதற்காக உங்கள் விரிவுரையாளர்கள் உங்களுடன் ஆசிரியர்களாக சிறந்த வழிகாட்டிகளாக சிறந்த நலன்புரி சேவையாளர்களாக எப்போதும் உங்களுக்கு துணையாக இருப்பார்கள் அரசாங்கம் வழங்கும் இலவச கல்வியானது உங்களுக்கு கிடைக்கும் ஒரு வரப்பிரசாதமாகும் இதனை சரியாக பயன்படுத்தி நாட்டுக்கும் நாட்டு மக்களுக்கும் சேவையாற்றும் சிறந்த ஆயுர்வேத மற்றும் யுனானி வைத்தியர்களாகவும் ஒரு நட்புரிஜையாகவும் வாழ வாழ்த்து கூறுகின்றார் நன்றி
Thank you very much. And as you all know, the Institute of Indigenous Medicine offers two degree programs. One, the Bachelor's of Ayurveda Medicine and Surgery. The next, Bachelor's of Yunani Medicine and Surgery. It was previously the head of Department of Ayurveda addressed the gathering. And now, let me formally invite the head Department of Study of Yunani. Acquiring the global perspective to fulfill The global requirements of healing the people with the Yunani medical system is strengthened by his valuable guidance. So, I kindly invite you, sir, Professor M.S.M. Shifa, to address the gathering.
Thank you. The Vice Chancellor of University of Colombo, Senior Professor Chandrika Vijayaratnam, ma'am. Director of Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Senior Professor Priyani Padmanabhan, Head of the Ayurveda Section, Dr. Mollikodam, Dr. Rajendra D. Silva, Senior Student Counselor of University of Colombo, Dr. Anoma Savarikrama, Student Counselor of Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Mr. Lalit Varnasoriya, Deputy Registrar of Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Major General P.L. Abhishekaran, Security Consultant, Academic, and non-academic staff of the IIM, parents, and my dear students. It's a great pleasure to welcome you all with warm greetings. Assalamu alaikum, ayubohan, vanakkam, and good morning. Today we are here to inaugurate your academic session in this way, though we did not expect to do like this. Whether we like it or not, we need to cope with the new situation. So we are happy to see you all through this webinar. Time is gone and no one can retrieve that. Keeping this in mind, our director and vice chancellor madam had taken the decision to initiate your academic session in this manner online. Therefore, I am really thankful to both of them, and also I want to thank all the academic and non-academic members who work hard to initiate your academic program and waiting to carry forward your academic activities without affecting your future. I also need to thank the IT department for their fullest support in this regard. I want to emphasize that why you are so lucky, because you are one of few students who sat the DCA level exam and got the chance to continue the tertiary education and also got a chance to join a professional medical degree program which aims to serve the health care services of the nation. This noble opportunity is not available in other in most of the other programs. Helping a patient to get rid of his problem will give you personal satisfaction, and I hope that you would be feel this after your successful career which starts now. This institution conducts two degree programs leading to BAMS and BUMS. Each department, Ayurveda and Unani, has 8 academic units which teach and train 23 subjects throughout in 3 steps, first, second and final optional study programs. We have a wonderful, well-qualified lecturers panel who are always ready to assist you whenever you need any you encounter any problem. And their assistance is not only limited to your education, but extend to look after your welfare as well. Therefore, you are always welcome to meet them whenever you need their assistance. If you have any problem, please let us know immediately. We have very effective mechanisms to address any kind of issues. Especially, you no need to worry about ragging. Previous speakers talked about that. So we have zero tolerance in ragging. It is worth to mention that we in this premises are working together peacefully, and request you all to join this friendly community and to be example for others as well. Madam Vice Chancellor and Director Madam, with your permission, I would like to speak a few words in Tamil for the interest of Tamil speaking freshmen. Pudumuga manavargale, pettorgale, ungal anaivarukkum assalamu alaikum, vanakkam. 2019-20 கல்வியாண்டிற்கு உங்கள் அனைவரையும் வரவேற்பதில் மிகுந்த மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகின்றோம். நாம் விரும்பினாலும் விரும்பாவிட்டாலும் COVID-19 ஏற்பட்டுள்ள இந்த புதிய சூழ்நிலையை சமாளிக்கவும் அதனிடமும் வாழவும் வேண்டும். காலம் பொன்னானது, அதை யாராலும் திரும்ப பெற முடியாது. இதை மனதில் வைத்து எங்கள் இயக்குநரும் துணைவேந்தர் அவர்களும் இன்று உங்கள் கல்வி அமர்வை இவ்வழியில், அதாவது ஆன்லைனில் தொடர்ந்து முடிவெடுத்தனர். ஆகையால் அவர் இருவருக்கும் நான் நன்றி செலுத்துகின்றேன். மேலும் உங்கள் கல்வி பயணத்தை தொடர்வதற்கும் தேவையான அனைத்து வேலைகளையும் உதவிகளையும் செய்த கல்வி மற்றும் கல்வி சாரா அனைத்து உறுப்பினர்களுக்கும் நன்றியை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்வதோடு உங்கள் எதிர்காலம் பாதிக்கப்படாமல் தொடர்ந்து உங்கள் கல்வி நடவடிக்கைகள் தொடர்ந்து முன்னெடுத்துப்பட செல்ல வேண்டும் என காத்திருக்கும் அனைத்து விரிவினர்களுக்கும் நான் நன்றி தெரிவிக்கின்றேன். மேலும் இது தொடர்பில் உதவி கொண்டிருக்கும் தகவல் தொழில்நுட்பத்துறையின் முழுமையான ஆதரவுக்கும் எனது நன்றியை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். நீங்கள் அனைவரும் எவ்வளவு அதிர்ஷ்டசாலிகள் என்றால், ஏலவல் பயிற்சிக்கு தோற்றிய மாணவர்களில் நீங்கள் சித்தி அடைந்து 3 நிலை கல்வியை தொடர்வதற்கு வாய்ப்பு உங்களுக்கு கிடைத்துள்ளதுடன் நாட்டின் சுகாதார சேவைகளுக்கு சேவை செய்வதை நோக்கமாக கொண்ட ஒரு தொழில்முறை மருத்துவ பட்டப்படிப்பில் சேரவும் உங்களுக்கு வாய்ப்பு கிடைத்துள்ளது. இந்த உன்னத வாய்ப்பு மற்றவர்களுக்கு கிடைக்கவில்லை. மேலும் ஒரு நோயாளியின் பிரச்சனையிலிருந்து விடுபட அவர்களுக்கு உதவுவது ஒரு பெரிய தர்மமாகும். அத்துடன் அது மன திருப்தியையும் தரும். இப்போது தொடங்கும் இக்கல்வியின் வெற்றிகரமான பயணத்தின் பின் இதை நீங்கள் நன்றாக உணர்வீர்கள். இந்த நிறுவனம் பிஏஎம்எஸ் மற்றும் பிஎம்எஸ் பாடத்திட்டங்களை நடத்துகின்றது. இவை இரண்டிலும் 8 கல்வி பிரிவுகள் உண்டு. அவை 23 பாடங்களை 3 படிமுறைகளில், முதலாம் இரண்டாம் இறுதி படிமுறைகளில் கற்பிக்கப்படுகின்றன. உங்களுக்கு உதவ எப்போதும் தயாராக உள்ள தகுதி வாய்ந்த விரிவுரையாளர் குழு ஒன்று எங்களிடம் உள்ளது. மேலும் அவர்கள் உதவி உங்கள் கல்விசார் நடவடிக்கைகளுக்கு மாத்திரமன்றி உங்களுடைய ஏனைய நலன்களுக்கும் அவர்களுடைய உதவியை பெற்றுக்கொள்ள முடியும். அத்துடன் அவர்கள் உதவிக்கு தேவைப்படும் போதெல்லாம் அவர்களை சந்திப்பதற்கு உங்களுக்கு எவ்வித தடையும் இல்லை. உங்களுக்கு ஏதேனும் சிக்கல் இருந்தால் தயவு செய்து உடனடியாக எங்களுக்கு தெரியப்படுத்துங்கள். எந்த ஒரு சிக்கலையும் தீர்க்கக்கூடிய சிறந்த பொறிமுறைகள் எங்களிடம் உள்ளன. பகிர்வதற்கு எதிரான சட்டங்கள் இங்கு கடுமையாக பின்பற்றப்படுவதால் குறிப்பாக நீங்கள் ரகிங் பகிர்வதை சம்பந்தமாக கவலைப்பட வேண்டிய அவசியம் இல்லை. இந்த வளாகத்தில் நாங்கள் அனைவரும் ஒன்றிணைந்து ஒற்றுமையாக ஒரு குடும்பமாக செயல்படுகின்றோம் என்பதை தெரிவிப்பதோடு இக்குடும்பத்தில் நீங்கள் இணைந்து மற்றவர்களுக்கும் முன்மாதிரியாக இருக்குமாறு உங்கள் அனைவரையும் கேட்டுக்கொள்கின்றோம். வாய்ப்பளித்த ஏற்பாட்டுக் குழுவிற்கு எனது நன்றியை தெரிவித்து இவ்வுரையை முடித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். ஐ தேங்க் த ஆர்கனைசிங் கமிட்டி ஃபார் கிவிங் மீ திஸ் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி அண்ட் ஐ கங்க்ராச்சுலேட் அண்ட் விஷ் ஆல் தி பெஸ்ட் ஃபார் தி நியூ மெம்பர்ஸ் அண்ட் வித் தட் ஐ வைண்ட் ஆஃப் மை ஷார்ட் ஸ்பீச். தேங்க் யூ வெரி மச்.
தேங்க்யூ சார். அதன அத்தியன கட்டளைக்கு ஆரம்பமில் தேசிய வைத்திய வித்யாலயே நவக சிஷ்யன் லெசைக்கு ஒப சமட்ட மாகே ஹிருதயாங்கம சுபாஷிஷனைய மேம மார்க்ககத எகத்துவட்ட எக்வன ஒப சம சாதரின் பிலிகன்ன அத்தர காலே வட்டினாக்கம இதா ஹொந்தின் அவபோத கருகானமின் கொலம்ப விஸ்வவித்யாலயே உபகுலபதி துமியன் சஹா தேசிய வைத்திய வித்யாலயத்தனே அத்தியக்ஷக துமியன் விசின் ஒபகே அத்தியன கட்டேது பமாவகின் தொரவ மெலச மார்க்ககத கிரமய ஒஸ்ஸே ஆரம்ப கரகனீமட கத் உற்சாகய பிலிபந்தவ மாகே கிருதஜ்ஞதாவய பலகிரீமட மெய அவஸ்தாவக் கொட்ட கனு லபனவா எம கர்த்தவியேதீ விஷால மெஹயக் இட்டுகொரண அபாயத்தனே அத்தியன சஹ அனத்தியன காரிய மண்டலியடத மெய மா ஸ்தூதிவந்த வீமட அவஸ்தாவக் கர கனு லபனவா அத்தியன பொது சகதிக பத்திர உசஸ்புல விபாகியன் அனுத்துருவ திருத்திய அத்தியாபனையட சுதுசுகம் லபன சீமித்த பிரிச அத்தர ஒப்ப இதா துர்லப அவஸ்தாவக் லபாகானே ஜனதாவட இமஹத் சேவையக் லபாதிய ஹகி வைத்திய வருத்திக்கிய குவேமே துர்லப அவஸ்தாவ உதா கரகன்னா நிசாவின் அபாயத்தனை விசின் பிரதான கருணு லபன பிரதான உபாதி பாட்டமாலாவன் அத்தரின் BUMS உபாதி பாட்டமாலாவின் விஷயப்பத விசித்துணக்கட அதால தனும ஒபவித்த லபாதியம சந்தகா சுதுசு கம்லத் விசிஷ்ட ஆச்சாரிய மண்டலையாக அபசத்துவ பவத்தினோம் அத்தியாபனிய மென்ம சிஷ்ய சுப்பசாதனைய சந்தகாத கெப்பவனு அப்ப ஆச்சாரிய மண்டலைய ஒபவித்த தனநகன ஒனேம கெட்டலுவாக் நிராகரணிய கரகனீம சந்தகா அவஷ்ய சேலம் கடையத்து ஒபவெனுவே செப்பையீமட்ட நிரந்தரைய நபகப்ப வீசிட்டினும் அத்த பெறப்பவசூலசம நவகவதையின் தொர விஸ்வவித்யால பூமியாக் பவட்ட அபாயத்தைய பத்வீம ஏ பிலிபந்த விஸ்வசனியத்வய தவதுரட்டத் தகவரு கரண்ணா அவசானேதி அபாயத்தனிய சாமகாமி சஹா மித்ரஷீலீவு பரிசய துல ஒப ஆதர்ஷவர்த்த ஒபகே அத்தியாபனைய ஒபகே நிபுணதாவியன் தியுனுக்கர கணிமின் பவத்வாதுனியனத்தை அபேக்ஷா கரமிந்த ஒபட்ட ஏ சந்தஹா தைரியல தேவாயை சுபாஷிஷன இக்கரமிந்த மாகே கதாவ அவசான் கொட சிட்டினவா கொலம்ப விஸ்வவித்யாலய தேசிய வைத்திய வித்யா ஆயத்தனே யுனானி அத்தியன அன்ஷையே அன்ஷ பிரதான மகாச்சாரிய MSM ஷிஃபா மெதிதுமான் மிசின் கல சபா ஆமந்திரணே சங்கிப்த சிங்கள பரிவர்த்தனைய அவசன் ஸ்தூதி.
Thank you very much, Professor MSM Shifa and the Sinhala translation. Right. So when we are speaking about an institute, we should definitely speak about the administrative hierarchy. apart from the administrative hierarchy, when we are gaining education, we should definitely discuss about the student welfare. So the official responsible in maintaining the student welfare activities without bothering your education. Let me invite the Deputy Registrar of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Mr. Lalit Varmasuriya, to address the gathering.
සියලු දෙනාටම සුබ දේශනක් වේවා. කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ උපකුලපති ජේෂ්ඨ මහාචාර්ය චන්ද්‍රිකා විජේරත්න මැතිතුමනි, ජේසිය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේ අධ්‍යක්ෂ ජේෂ්ඨ මහාචාර්ය ප්‍රියාණී පර්ණගම මැතිතුමනි, ජේෂ්ඨ ශිෂ්‍ය උපදේශක කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ආචාර්ය රාජිත සිල්වා, ආයුර්වේද අන්ත ප්‍රධාන ආචාර්ය එස් පී මොල්ලිගොඩ, යුනානි අන්ත ප්‍රධාන මහාචාර්ය එම් එස් එම් සිපා, ආරක්ෂක උපදේශක මේජර් ජෙනරාල් පියල් අබේසේකර, දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේ ජ්‍යෙෂ්ඨ ශිෂ්‍ය උපදේශක ඩොක්ටර් අනුමා සමරවික්‍රම, මෙම නම් නීකරණ වැඩසටහනේ සංවිධායක ප්‍රධාන ඩොක්ටර් කෞමලී කරුණාකර ඇතුළු මේ අවස්ථාවට සම්බන්ධ වෙලා ඉන්න දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේ සියලුම ආචාර්ය මහාචාර්යවරු ප්‍රමුඛ සීර්වාදින කාර්ය මණ්ඩලයේ ඒ වගේම අනත් දින කාර්ය මණ්ඩලින් අවසරයි. 2019 20 අධ්‍යයන වසරේ සදා දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේ තේරීපත් වී සිටින දයාපර සිසු දරුවනි, එසේම දයාපර මව්පියවරු, මෙම අවස්ථාව විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයක අධ්‍යයන කැලැන්ඩරය තුළ ඉතාම වැදගත් ස්ථානයක් දරන අවස්ථාවක්. විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ අඛණ්ඩ පැවැත්ම පවතින්නේ නවක සිසුන්ගේ පැමිණීම සමග. නවක සිසුන්ගේ පැමිණීම නැවතුනොත් විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ අඛණ්ඩ පැවැත්ම සිද්ධ වෙන්නේ නැහැ. මේ අවස්ථාව විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට තේරියපත් වූ සීලම ශිෂ්‍යයන්ට ඉතාම වැදගත් අවස්ථාවක් වෙනවා. මට මතකයි මීට අවුරුදු හරියටම 30කට කලින් මම මේ අවස්ථාවට මුහුණ දුනා කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ නව කලාකාරයේදී නවක නාමීකරණ වැඩසටහන. එම නිසා මම දන්නවා ශිෂ්‍යයන් හැටියට මේ අවස්ථාව විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේදී කොච්චර තමන්ගේ හිතට දැනෙන දෙයක්ද කියලා. නමුත් අවසනාවකට අපිට එකිනෙකා ඉදිරියේදී මේ අවස්ථාව සිදු කිරීමට මේ අවස්ථාවේ අපිට ඉඩ ලැබිලා නැහැ. ඒ වගේම පසුගිය අවුරුදු දෙක තුනක් අපිට මේ විදිහට තමයි දුරස්ත භාවයේ දැකගැනීමෙන් මේ කාර්ය කිරීමේදී තියෙන්නේ. ඒ වගේම මට මතකයි දැන් අපි මුහුණ දෙනා වගේම වසංගත තත්ත්වයක් එදා මම විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට තේරීත් 1988 කාලයේ තිබුණා. එම කාලේ අපි විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට තේරිලා අවුරුදු 3ක් ගෙදර හිටියා. අපිට මේ ඔන්ලයින් පහසුකම් ලැබීමේ අවස්ථාව ඒ කාලේ තිබුණේ නැහැ. අපි හරියටම අවුරුදු 3ක් ගෙදර ඉඳලා තමයි විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට ආවේ. ඒ අතින් වර්තමානයේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට තේරීපත් වෙලා ඉන්න ඔබ තිර දින වාසනාවන්තයි කියලා මම හිතනවා. මොකද ඔබගේ කාල ඔබට එකම ගැටළු වෙලා තියෙන විශ්වවිද්‍යාල තුරට අද දින පැමිණීමට නොහැකිවීම. නමුත් මාර්ගගත ක්‍රමයේදී අඛණ්ඩව ඔබගේ අධ්‍යයන කටයුතු අද සිට ඉදිරියට පැවැත්වේ. ඒ නිසා අද සිට ඉදිරි වසර 6 අවම වශයෙන් ඔබ කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යායතනයේ ශිෂ්‍යෙක් හැටියට කටයුතු කරනවා. මෙම වසර 6 අවසන් වෙනකොට ඔබ වගකිව යුතු සමාජ සත්කාරය ලබන පිළිගැනීම ලබන වෛද්‍යවරයෙකු ලෙස සමාජයට පිටවෙන්නේ. ඒ නිසා ඔබට විශාල වගකීමක් තිබෙනවා මේ අවුරුදු 6 අඛණ්ඩව කැප වෙලා ඔබගේ කටයුතු සිදු කර ගැනීම. ඔබට මේ අවුරුදු 6 තුළදී ඔබගේ ශාස්ත්‍රයේ ඉන්න හොඳම ආචාර්ය මණ්ඩලෙ මේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය තුළදී ලැබෙනවා. ඔබගේ යුතුකම තමයි ඒ කාලේ අඛණ්ඩව අධ්‍යයන කටයුතු සඳහා ප්‍රමුඛත්වය ලබා දීම. අදාළ විභාගයන් සමත් වෙලා ඉතා ඉක්මනින් උපාධිධාරී කලෙස පිටවීමයි. මොකද විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයකදී අපිට වගකීමක් තිබුණා නවක ශිෂ්‍යකදී ඔබ ගන්නවා වගේම ඉතා ඉක්මනින් ඔබ සමාජයට දායාද කිරීම අපස. එම නිසා අපි ඉල්ලා සිටින්නේ අවුරුදු 6 තුළ මේ උපාධි පාඨමාලාව සම්පූර්ණ කරගෙන පිටවීම කරන්න. මොකද මම මෙහෙම කියන්නේ අපිට අධ්‍යක්ෂක කියන සමහර අය ඉන්නවා අවුරුදු 10 පාඨමාලාවට ඇවිල්ලා අවුරුදු 10ක් අතර කරන. සමහර විට මේ වගේ ඉස්කෝලේට බාර දෙන්නා නම් ළමෙක් එයා අවුරුදු 10ක් වෙනකොට ඕලෙවල් දිනන සමහර ළමයි ඉන්නවා ඊතරම් කාලයක් විශ්වවිද්‍යාලෙ ඉන්න. ඒ නිසා විශ්වවිද්‍යාල ශිෂ්‍යෙක් ඇදී මම ඉල්ලා සිටිනවා අද සිට ඔබ දැඩි තීරණයකට ආයුතුයි මේම පාඩය નિયમિત අවුරුදු තුල සම්පූර්ණ කරලා යනවා. ඒ වගේම ඔබ මෙතෙක් විශ්වවිද්‍යාල තෝරා ගැනීමේ කාර්යය යටතේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල ප්‍රතිපාදන කොමිෂන් සභාව සහ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල පරිපාලන යටතේ දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේදී ලියා වාණිජ කටයුතු සඳහා පරිපාලන අංශ භාරය පමණයි සිටි. ඔබ අද සිට දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේ ආචාර්ය මණ්ඩලය වෙත ඔබව නිරාවරණය කරනවා. අද සිට ඉදිරි අවුරුදු 6 එම ආචාර්ය මණ්ඩලය සමග ඔබ ඔබගේ කටයුතු කළ යුතුයි. ඔබගේ හමුවීම ඉතා හොඳ මට්ටමින් සිදු කිරීම සඳහා අවශ්‍ය පහසුකම් සැපයීම පරිපාලන කාර්ය මණ්ඩලයේ සිට විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ අප විසින් ඉදිරිපත් කරන අවශ්‍ය සම්පත් සපයා දීමින් විවිධ වූ බාධාවන්ට යටත්ව සීමාවන්ට යටත්ව මොකද විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය කියන්නේ රජයේ මුදල් ප්‍රතිපාදන මත සිද්ධ කරන වියදම් කරන ආයතන. එම නිසා සමහර විට විවිධ බාධාවන් දුෂ්කරතාවයන් තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. නමුත් අපගේ කාර්ය උපකොලිතුමිය සහ අධ්‍යක්ෂකතුමියගේ උපදෙස් පරිදි ඉතාම උපරිම මට්ටමින් සිදු කිරීම තමයි අපි බලාපොරොත්තු. මට මේ අවස්ථාවේ සහතික වෙන්න පුළුවන් කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ඔබ විට ලැබෙන සැලකිල්ල අපේ උපකොලිතුමිය සහ අධ්‍යක්ෂකතුමිය විසින් ලබා දෙන සැලකිල්ල වෙන කිසිදු දෙමාපිය කෙනෙක් දරුවන් වෙත කරන සැලකිල්ලට නොදෙවෙනි සැලකිල්ලක්. ඒ නිසා extraterm සැලකිල්ලෙන් ඔබ වෙනුවෙන් කටයුතු කරනවා. එම නිසාම තමයි මේ විවිධ දුෂ්කරතා මැදේ උනත් ඔබගේ අධ්‍යයන කටයුතු පහා කරන්නේ නැතුව මේ විදිහට ආරම්භ කිරීමට කටයුතු කරනවා. ඒ අවශ්‍ය උපදෙස් සඳහා ඔබට අවශ්‍ය සහයෝගය ලබා දීම සඳහා විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ විවිධ මට්ටමේ නිලධාරීන් පත් කරලා සිටිනවා. ඔබගේ ශිෂ්‍ය සුබදා දෙන කටයුතු සඳහා ශිෂ්‍ය සේවා අංශයට ඔබට නිතර කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඔබට අනිකුත් අවශ්‍ය උපදේශන කටයුතු සඳහා ශිෂ්‍ය උපදේශන සේවාවල් තිබෙනවා. ඒ අය සඳහා ඔබට අවශ්‍ය අවස්ථාවලදී සහයෝගයෙන් කටයුතු කරගෙන කටයුතු සිද්ධ කරගන්න පුළුවන්. එසේම මම මේ අවස්ථාවේ දයාපර දෙමාපියන්ගෙන් ඉල්ලා සිටිනවා මේ අවස්ථාව ඔබ මෙතෙක් කල දරු උත්සාහය ප්‍රමාණවත් ගැනෙන අවස්ථාවක්. නමුත් තවම ඒ ක්‍රියාවලිය අවසන් වෙලා නැහැ. ඉදිරි වසර 6 ඉතාම තීරණාත්මකයි. එම 6 කටයුතු කරන ආකාරය ඉදිරි කාලයේ මුළු ජීවිත කාලයටම සමාපේට බලපාන්න පුළුවන්. අද gedare hitiyat මුතත්ත්‍ය වසංගරි තත්ත්‍ය වෙනස් වූ අවස්ථාවේදී විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට පැමිණෙන්න සිද්ධ වෙනවා. ඔබට එන්න තියෙන්නේ කොළඹට. සමහර විට සමහර අය කොළඹට පැමිණෙන පළවෙනි අවස්ථාව වෙනකොට කොළඹ දිගට හුරු සමාජයේ එකපාරටම ලැබෙන්න තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. ඔබගේ දරුවා ගැන ඉතාම සැලකිල්ලෙන් බලන්න ඕනේ. අධ්‍යයන කටයුතු කරනවාද විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ ඉන්නවාද එහෙම නැත්නම් බෝඩිමේ ඉන්නවද වෙන කවුරු හරි එක්කද ඉන්නේ කියන එක සලකා බලන්න ඕනේ. ශිෂ්‍ය විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයට පැමිණීමෙන් දෙමාපියන්ගේ වගකීම අවසන් වෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඒ වගේම ශිෂ්‍යයන් තමන්ට අදාළ ශිෂ්‍ය නීතිරීදී මීට කලින් කතා කළ උපකොලිතුමිය අධ්‍යක්ෂතුමිය ඒ වගේම ජේසුස් ශිෂ්‍ය උපදේශකතුමා කිව්ව ආකාරයට ඔබ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ නීතිරීදී शिष्य विनय नीति नवकवदेवन विभाग संबंध नीति रीति अमीटने दनतम दाल शिष्य अद्भुत वेबसाइट अपलोड कर लिखवाई इवागे मिट्टी वस्ते मेम नामीकरण वेटा दीपे ये पील धनवाम लगे विभाग कार्यकिल धन का विभाग इधर हाईक कार्यकट लक्ष्मी मेम नामीकरण इधर वेटी मम ये पील अजहसाकी बलो එමනිසා මේ අවස්ථාව වැදගත් වගේම මේ ආරම්භක අවස්ථාව ඉදිරි අවුරුදු 6ම ඉතාම වැදගත් අවස්ථාවක්. ඔබ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය තුල පැමිණි විගත ඔබට විවිධ සමාජ ස්තරවලින් විවිධ සමාජීය පරිසරයන් වලින් ආපු යහළුවන් හමු වෙන්න පුළුවන්. ඔබ ඒ විවිධත්වය පිළිගත යුතුයි. ඒ විවිධත්වයේ සුන්දරත්වය ඔබ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලය තුළ විඳීමට සූදානම් විය යුතුයි. එහෙම පිටියොත් තමයි ඔබට විශ්වවිද්‍යාල කාලය ඉතා හොඳ සතුටුදායක මට්ටමකට පවත්වා ගැනීමට හැකියාව ලැබෙයි. එහෙම කියන ගමන් ඉදිරි අවසර 6ක කාලය ඔබගේ අධ්‍යයන කටයුතු सर्व प्रकार सार्थक गलगन वसर हय कि अद्यन कथित संपूर्ण करार्थना करण विथ दिस आई वुड लाइक टू गिव ब्रीफ समरी ऑफ माय स्पीच इन इंग्लिश डियर स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द लीडिंग यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ श्रीलंका प्रेजेंटली नंबर वन रैंकिंग यूनिवर्सिटी इन श्रीलंका इज यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कोलंबो and welcome to Institute of Indigenous Medicine. For us in the IIM, today is the highly important day in the university calendar of the university. It is a great pleasure to welcome you all for the orientation of our new batch of students for the academic year 2019-20. I can remember the day exactly 30 years ago, where I was a university student of the University of Colombo, so I know the importance of this day for the university student. I hope IIM will be your new home at least for next 6 years, that is 5 academic levels and 1 year internship period. So my request is, just forget the immediate challenges for a moment like COVID-19. Think of a long-term perspective. Through these 6 years of time, IIM will transform you into a different, capable, and important person and introduce you into the society through a series of academic activities. In such an effort, I wish you to think COVID-19 pandemic as a small issue and as a short-term threat. And whatever life and studying can be exactly that and can anytime be challenged by the unknown things and also even things that cannot imagine until it comes to us. There is a big difference between school and university. You just being a university student, you get wider recognition and respect from the society. At the same time, you are assigned with a big responsibility towards the society. From today onwards, according to the orientation program schedule, you are going to have a series of sessions and presentations allowing you to have a good understanding about the university environment, academic programs, rules and regulations, and student discipline. Further, hostel facilities and examinations. You may get the copy of the student handbook with lot of information about the university academic programs and other rules and regulations. So you all need to read it at least once, because in the university, consider you know all the laws. If you violate it, we can't undo those things. We have to take actions. We have to protect the discipline within the university. Within the university, you need to prepare to enter into a different environment where you are going to meet people or other friends from different parts of the country. You must prepare to enjoy the beauty of privacy within the university. Need to accept and respect each other's social condition, since the originality is always noble, need to be respected by all. Until today, you are under the administration of the university, earlier you are under the UGC for the selection process, and later you communicated with the IIM administration for the registration. After this orientation, you are exposed or introduced to the academic staff of the university. You are expected to meet lecturers, academics in your departments, Ayurveda and Unani, during your entire university period. For that, administrations are there always to make that meeting a memorable one. Within the university, you will have several staff categories, including vice chancellor, registrar, director, sectional heads, wardens, student counselors, marshal officers, and non-academic staff for your support. Administration will take every effort to make it a success, although it is subject to many difficulties such as financial as well as other resources. But I can assure you that the service you are going to get from the university will be similar to a parent's pay towards their children. So, therefore, dear students, I would like to request you to focus strong and things will change, and let all be hope everything will be changed in the positive way. විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ පරිපාලන කාර්ය මණ්ඩලය නියෝජනය කරමින් මේ අවස්ථාව ලබා දීම පිළිබඳව විශේෂයෙන් මේ අවස්ථාව සංවිධානය කමිටුවේ තමාගේ ස්තුතිය ප්‍රකාශ කරනවා. ඒ වගේම මේ අවස්ථාවේ අවශ්‍ය සේවා සපයීම වෙනුවෙන් දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යාලයේ පරිගණක පංචයට මාගේ විශේෂ ස්තුතිය මේ අවස්ථාවේ ප්‍රකාශ කරනවා. ඒ වගේම මේ සඳහා අපිට උපදේශ මග පෙන්වීම විතරම ලබා දෙන කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාල ප්‍රකොලිතුමා ලේකාධිකාරතුමා දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යායතනයේ අධ්‍යක්ෂතුමිය ඇතුළු මේ සංවිධානය මණ්ඩලයේ මාගේ ස්තුතිය පරිපාලන කාර්ය මණ්ඩලයේ වශයෙන් මේ අවස්ථාවේ පුද කරවීම මග වචන කෘත්‍ය අවසන් කරන සියලු දෙනාට ස්තුතියි.
Thank you sir, thank you very much. It was Mr. Lalit Veerasuriya, the Deputy Registrar of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine. Within an institute, there should be a proper security methodology. So at this orientation program, we are moving little by little to the end. So I would like to invite the security consultant head of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Major General Piala Besekara. Sir, I would like to coordinate and invite you to the podium.
BC Madam, Columbia University, IIM Madam, Madam Director Madam IIM, Senior Student Counselor, Columbia University, heads of Ayurveda Nani IIM, Deputy Registrar IIM, academic staff, non-academic staff, administrative staff of IIM, my dear students of 2019-20 batch with their parents and their relatives and all the listeners. Ayubhavan, vanakkam, assalamualaikum. I am Regional PL Abhishekara, a security consultant. In my short speech, I would like to bring out two things. Firstly, let me congratulate all of you getting selected into this program and the curriculum. And let me welcome you to IIM. I would like to tell you, you as a batch 2019-20, develop a sense of batch feeling, where you all as individual and together have this batch feeling and be proud of your batch. This is where you start your career. You have to go a long way. It is not finishing either 1 year, 2 years, 5 years or 6 years. You are going to be doctors in this country, responsible people. So this batch feeling will bring you a lot of things. You develop a sense of responsibility in life. Whatever you do from the day one, be responsible. So even if the slightest damage is happening to your batch, have a feeling. Don't let it happen. Ensure that your batch move forward very strongly, together, unitedly, so that this institution will support you to achieve all your goals, where you will become a very valuable doctor in this country and serve the country. So today is day one. You are stepping into an institution which has a long history. With another 8 years time, it's going to be 100 years. So have this value in you all the time. Never forget this a moment even. If you develop this, I can assure you, you will reach very high levels in your academics. Who will be the most happiest in your achievement? None other than your parents. Making parents happy is the most important thing in your life. If you do that, you are successful in your life. So do that. We are there to support you. So, sense of responsibility. All these things should be developed in a platform called discipline. Discipline is the most important thing in all of us. You've been people going to be doctors. It is very, very important. Doctors' discipline will make the patients cure as they appear in front of a doctor. No need to give medicine. Medicine will come afterwards. So remember, discipline, you have to culture, you have to develop. I, as army officer, I was introduced to discipline as a civilian. Their own words, I am a disciplined man. Even today, you can see my tie. It's an army tie. So what else to tell? You feel yourself. You are a very recognized, important person. So develop yourself based on a discipline. Your platform is discipline. Lay your foundation. Build your building on discipline and make the building strong. One day, you as a doctor, you will house in this building and shelter many people. That is your achievement. So take this word into your head, this advice. One day, you will be very successful. All of us will be happy. There are very good academic staff in this institution who have been graduated from this institution itself. So they have a lot of affiliation. So you have a lot of strength. You get that and make use of it for your betterment, betterment of the country, of the people of this country. So don't forget. Remember all these things. We are behind you. We are to support you. All aspects, every one in this institution will be there for you. Okay, my dear students, next most important thing I want to tell you, which all of us are very much aware, that is none other than health security. Health security is most important in this country, even in the world today. So we have to follow all the health precautionary measures and ensure we are healthy and we move forward strongly. You are not stopping anywhere. You are moving forward. That is why even this program here today, to get you move forward as the new batch. So follow the health guidelines, safety measures, which we have been doing in this institution. I'm telling you, up to now, there's only one staff and one student positive. We have managed that. But how? That is following these guidelines very, very strong. Those two brought the infection in, but we didn't allow to spread. We got them admitted, took immediate action and controlled the situation. Therefore, we have no other positive cases. We are maintaining that. So remember, you at home, follow all these instructions very strongly. And even if you come into the institution, it is the same. We are watching you. At the entrance, you have to follow all those instructions. We are watching you. We are guiding you. We are helping you to be healthy and continuing your studies. So that one day, you assure you will be a very good doctor. That is our hope. That is our prayer. So that is our expectation. So remember, do well with a very good batch feeling, sense of responsibility, based on discipline, and achieve high results. I wish you, all the 237 students, a happy and a successful future and a career in your profession, what you are going to learn. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for those inspirational words. Major General P.L. Abhesekara, the security consultant of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it is the time we need. As the ancient proverb, we know, ounce of prevention is worth than pound of cure. So let's be safe and make this world a pleasant environment after this pandemic. So adopting to the new normal, we have conducted this orientation program and step by step, we are moving to the end. So formally, to deliver the vote of thanks, I would like to invite a distinguished personality. So when you come to the institute, there will be certain academic things and extracurricular things. So the student consultants, student counselors rather, they will help you to proceed forward as medical professionals in the future and to accomplish your perspectives with regard to your degree program. So let me invite senior lecturer, Dr. A.G. Samaravikrama, the senior assistant student counselor of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, to present the word of thanks for the orientation program 2019-2020.
Good morning, everyone. Senior Professor Chandrika N. Vijayaratna, Vice Chancellor, University of Colombo. Senior Professor Priyani Paranagama, Director, Institute of Indigenous Medicine. Dr. Rajita Da Silva, Senior Student Counselor, University of Colombo. Sectional Head Ayurveda, Senior Lecturer, Dr. Susanta Mollygoda. Professor M.S.F. Shifa, Sectional Head, Yunani. Mr. Lalit Varnasuriya, Deputy Registrar. Mr. P.L. Abhesekara, Security Consultant. All the heads of units, members of the academic staff, administrative staff, non-academic staff, parents, and my dear students. It gives me an immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks for orientation program academic year 19-2020, Institute of Indigenous Medicine, University of Colombo. On behalf of the entire institute, I would like to express my deepest gratitude, Vice Chancellor Madam Chandrika N. Vijayaratna, honored this function with her inspirational thoughts. Madam, for your encouragement, support, and affection inspired us immensely. Thank you, Madam. I wish to express my most sincere appreciation with deepest gratitude, our Director Madam, senior professor Priyani Paranagamma. Madam, for your generous assistance, invaluable advices and guidance, motivation and dedication rendered this institute and successful completion of this orientation program. Thank you, madam. I extremely thanks Dr. Rajita Da Silva, Senior Student Counselor, University of Colombo, for gracing this event and sharing your valuable experience with our newcomers. I wish to sincere thanks with profound respect to our sectional head, Ayurveda, Senior Lecturer, Dr. Susanta Mollikodar, for her excellent supervision, advice, and valuable contribution to all the academic program complete on time and making this event successful. I would like to express my sincere thanks to Professor M.S.F. Shifa, Sectional Head Yunani, for making this event as a grand success. I extremely thanks Deputy Registrar Mr. Dalit Varnasuriya, Mr. P.R. Labesekara, Security Consultant, for their valuable contribution and their sharing their knowledge with our students. It gives an immense pleasure with special acknowledge the program coordinators, Senior Lecturer Dr. Kamadi Karunagoda and Lecturer Dr. Iswana, Head IT Section, Senior Lecturer Dr. S.M. Samarakorn, all the heads of units, members of the academic staff, administrative and non-academic staff. I must not forget to thank today's announcing team, Dr. Dilupa Nanayakkara, Dr. Nafla Nisar, and Mr. Charit Minipurarachi. The network manager, Mr. Lahiru Chamara, IT instructor, Mr. Ruan Kohumbakanda and Ms. Nalindra Balasuriya, members of the IT staff, Mr. Buddhika Rajaguru and Mr. Jayakodi, management assistant, Mr. Prasanna Veerasinghe, successful organizing of this online orientation program until the last moment. They always help us in carrying out such important tasks. Thank you very much. It's my profound duty to thank all the students who joined with IIM family and their parents. I once again thank everyone for making this online orientation program successful. Finally, I would like to say Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Shakshat Param Brahma, Tasmahi Gaurava Namaha. Stay safe. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Madam. Senior Lecturer Dr. A.G. Samara Vikrama, Student Counselor of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, for your valuable and worthy speech delivering on word of thanks. Nanavidhu Samaja Sandarbayan, Sanskrutin Saha Sankalpayan Tulin, Ek Aragunak Vemen, Ada Oban Upper Vihesavan Navy. රෝගකින් පීඩිත වූ සුවහසක් ජන දිවිය සුවපත් කිරීමේ අනාගත පරපුර ලෙස ඔබ අද දින අප සමග එක්වීම අපහට ඉමහත් සතුටක්. මෙතෙන් පටන්
උසස් ප්‍රමිතියෙන් ගෙන් යුතු සේවය සමාජය වෙත ලබා දෙමින් සෞඛ්‍ය ප්‍රවර්ධනයේලා උත්සුක වීමේ වගකීමේ ඔබද කොටස්කරුවෙකු වනු ඇත. සිය ආයතනීය වගකීම නිරන්තරයෙන් ඔබ වෙනුවෙන් ඉටු කරමින් අධ්‍යාපනයේ සුභ සිද්ධිය උදෙසා අවශ්‍ය පරිසරය සහ සුභ සාධනය පවත්වා ගනිමින් කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලීය දේශීය වෛද්‍ය විද්‍යා ආයතනය ඔබට තන්නරය ලැබීමට මඟ පෙන්වා දෙනු ඇත. ඊට ඇවසි මූලික අඩිතාලම සඳහා ඔබව දැනුවත් කිරීමේ මාර්ගගත දේශන සැසිවාර මාලාවක් හෙට දින සිට පුරා දින 4ක් ඔබ වෙනුවෙන් සංවිධානය කෙරෙනු ඇත. ඒ සඳහා අවශ්‍ය තොරතුරු මේ වන විටත් ඔබ වෙත දැනුම් දී ඇති අතර ඔබගේ සහභාගීත්වය අපි අපේක්ෂා කරන්නෙමු. මෙම දුෂ්කර සමය පහව ගිය වහාම වෛද්‍යවරයෙකු වීමේ ප්‍රායෝගික අත්දැකීමේ පූර්ව පුහුණුව සඳහා ඔබ අප සැමට එකට එක්ව පියනගන්නට හැකි වේයයි අපි අපේක්ෂා කරන්නෙමු. ඉදින් අධ්‍යන වර්ෂ 2019-2020 ශිෂ්‍ය කණ්ඩායමේ සරසවි ප්‍රවිෂ්ඨයේ සමාරම්භක උළෙල හා සුසැඳි අනාගත පරපුරේ ජීවක ඔබට සුවපත් ලොවක් තනන්නට සුබ පැතුම් එක් කරමින් අද දින වැඩසටහනේ නිමාව මෙලෙස සනිටුහන් කරනවා. ඔබ සැමට සුබ අනාගතයක් ආයුබෝවන්.
சந்தர்ப்பத்தை சரியாக பயன்படுத்தி அதி உன்னத நிலையை அடைய முயற்சி செய்வது உங்களது பாரிய பொறுப்பாக இருக்கும். இந்த நிலையில் தொடர்ந்து வரும் இணையதள விரிவுரைகளில் சில முக்கியமான அறிமுக விரிவுரைகளுக்கு உற்சாகமாக பங்கு பற்றி பயன்பெறுவதோடு வரும் திங்கட்கிழமை முதல் அனைத்து பாட விரிவுரைகளும் நேர அட்டவணையின்படி இணையதளம் மூலம் நடக்கவிருப்பதால் உன்னாட்டு மருத்துவ நிறுவனத்தின் இணையதள முகவரியோடு என்றும் இணைந்திருங்கள். நன்றி. வசலாம்.
Step by step, we came to the end. The batch 2019-2020 is now the newest and the youngest batch of the Institute of Indigenous Medicine. If you could remember our debut registrar's speech from 1987, he was staying at home for 3 years until the university admissions. Why? Because of the pandemic situation. But with the technological movement and adoption of the new normal, the Institute of Indigenous Medicine has never forget the new batch. So proceeding the academic activities with your benefit, with an eminent panel of lecturers, well equipped academic staff, we are proceeding your medical education. This is not performing and building, molding a doctor online. So until the online sessions will be carried out till the pandemic is over, and if we can accumulate physically, there will be physical sessions, practical demonstrations, and many other activities related with your academic career. So building a professional is not possible online, but adapting to the new normal, we are conducting lectures online. So if you could remember, the Institute of Indigenous Medicine is one of the pioneering institute who implemented the online teaching methodology once the pandemic started. So we were able to get benefit of the experience of the lecturers and many other resources despite of the pandemic situation. So ladies and gentlemen, now it's a great privilege for us to enroll as medical students here. Parents, you take extra care of your children. So Colombo might be new to many of the students. So wherever the place they stay, they should be safe and fine. So the care given by the parents, without being second to that, the Institute of Indigenous Medicine, Madam Director, the academic staff comprised of the heads of the Institute will provide that safe environment with the assistance of the senior students counselors and students counselors of the University of Colombo and the Institute of Indigenous Medicine for your own benefit. We wear beautiful clothes to glamour in front of the society. You will be having a special cloth, a white coat. So wear the white coat with pride and dignity. It's an absolute honor and privilege for you all to wear the white coat and serve the public. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you all. Thank you very much. Stay safe. So let's wind up this session and stand for the national anthem.
Yeah.